brave you must be. A great challenge, have you?
Holy crap, Lois.
I don't know why Yoda's a Family Guy.
Better get set. Better get ready. Better get set to go. For racers fly, fly right through the sky.
Folks, it's Multimedia Monday, and what is this? I sound weird. What's going on here? Alex, explain yourself.
I sound weird, too.
You sound extra weird. What the hell? It doesn't sound like you're shouting at the end of a hallway. Oh, my God. What is happening? Shit. Well, I went and fucked with all of our audio setup. Yep, the audio settings that have worked so well for us over the last 5 years. that being a snowball Yeti perched atop a freaking boom mic and just set to omnidirectional recording. Turns out maybe you can do a little bit better than that, maybe slightly better. So we replaced that with an actual audio mixer and a couple of Shure SM58s, and we're gonna see how that works. I predict this will be a disaster at first. Like, if y'all remember when Macaw switched from his freaking headset that served him so well for so many years to an actual professional microphone, it sounded really like shit for a couple weeks. Then it sounded okay. I figure we'll be okay after the next couple weeks. But for now, this is gonna... I don't know. I still don't know about this. I'm running all kinds of cables. I have unfamiliar equipment just dangling off the computer. But yeah, this is a testbed stream. I figure if we're ever gonna do this, we're going to do it during a Jar Jar stream, because if anything goes completely wrong, I'm going to blame it all on Jar Jar Binks. What do you say, Alex?
Yes, blame Jar Jar. Also, for some reason, the captioning service isn't picking up me. Oh, there it goes. There it goes. Okay, it's just a little delayed. Never mind. It's picking me up more than it used to.
Okay, so just to set some expectations, this is an experimental stream. Things will probably get better over the next few weeks. This is just an initial test run. In particular, we're looking for feedback. If anything is especially broken, feel free to message us right now. Otherwise, just wait till the end of the stream, and I'll listen to it myself and examine people's feedback. If you're a professional audio mixer and want to give us some settings that'll work perfectly every time, feel free. I have a feeling it's not that simple, though. It's something we're all going to work through, and we're only going to get through it together. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm coming through a little quieter, but that's something we're going to need to adjust in the settings. But it also could be because I am not used to having to talk into a mic directly, and there's one in front of me, and...
Yeah, it sucks. We're like actual studio musicians now. Like we're recording a podcast or something. Thank you to Hulix for the 21 months. If each month was a year, my sub could legally drink. Congratulations to your subscription, and it's the mini alcoholic drinks it'll have.
I was going to say, get some. What are they drinking? I'm the Star Wars nerd. I don't know what they drink in Star Wars. Get a Gungan grog. I don't know.
Boy, what a great day it is to talk about Star Wars. Well, we got a whole bunch of Star Wars games to play. We're going to learn and have fun with our friend Jar Jar Binks.
Yes.
It was recently Alex's birthday, and to celebrate, we rewatched Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace. Enjoyed it again for the first time.
Did you know that movie is 2.5 hours? Because I had totally forgotten until...
And all of it is inessential except for the pod race scene. I almost called it a podcast scene. I'd have loved it if Jar Jar started his own podcast midway through the movie. That would rule. Someone recut it.
Okay, yeah, there is alcohol. There is alcohol in that universe and everything. And, oh, people like that they can hear me. Yes, Focus Maple, who wants to get us in trouble, says, Star Wars is bad. Is it bad? We'll find out.
Let's discuss it. Today's topic, is Star Wars good or bad? Have at it, folks. just like throwing a big steak into the lion's den.
I have to moderate. Please don't.
You have to moderate and deal with a new audio setup and play these godforsaken games. Alex has his plate full, but me, I'm just going to sit back and watch the carnage unfold.
All right, let me do one thing before we get started, and let me just adjust a couple of settings, and then we can go. So, also, I do not know how to say this nicely. Please be normal about Star Wars in chat. I don't want to have to moderate.
Yeah,
there's
other Star Wars things going on today, but that's outside the scope of the stream.
Yes, it is.
Now, we're transporting ourselves back in time, 20 years, to when Star Wars Episode 1 was finally going to happen. Something all of our collective moms and dads freaked out over, those who were Star Wars fans anyway. Mm-hmm. They were all like, oh, George Lucas is going to come out with prequels, and then there's going to be sequels. It's going to be amazing. And then it finally happened, and here we are.
So Lucas Learning actually is, so what we're doing today is Luke is less of a, so that's the backdrop from when Lucas Learning started releasing games. Lucas Learning, we're getting this all from Wikipedia.
Oh, have you heard of the site, folks? Wikipedia. It's like Wikipedia, but different.
So, Lucas Learning, I'm just going to read straight from Wikipedia, was a subsidiary of LucasArts in order to provide challenging, engaging, and fun educational software for classrooms. They talk about how good the games are, blah, blah, blah. Company was located in San Rafael, California, and was headed by former MECC Senior Vice President of Development and Creative Director Susan Schilling.
Ah, MECC, the creators of the old Oregon Trail. Mm-hmm. I've seen a couple comments saying you're a little quiet. You can boost your gain on the mixer if you like.
Okay.
Maybe we should be about even. It seems to do a good job of handling peaking, but we'll see.
Okay, is this better? Or is this too loud? Let me know if this is better, folks. So, okay, cool. So they, Schilling asserted that Lucas was personally involved with the products and that a company mantra was to stay away from violence. Keep that in mind.
Uh-huh.
They released games from 1998 until announcing their cancellation of a Mac version of Star Wars Super Bombad Racing. Yes, they developed Super Bombad Racing.
Oh, that's not a great time span there, because Super Bombad Racing was in mid-2001, and they started in 1998. So, wow, just like a few years was all it took for them to just take a dive.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you to Noel Problems for 39 months, a.k.a. 39 years of Jar Jar.
That's a lot of Jar Jar.
Jar Jar is almost old enough to drink in Gungan years.
So Lucas Learning in 2001 was eventually reorganized into Edutopia, or the George Lucas Educational Foundation, which is independent from Lucasfilms Limited. So yeah, they started in 1998, and they closed shop around 2001, but their last game came out in, like, I think Super Bombad came out 2001 as well, so.
This kind of mirrors another particular industry. You'll remember Williams Pinball was riding high on licenses at that point. They went all in on Episode 1. They invented a new type of pinball machine that used holograms, or, you know, just kind of fakery. It was really cool, but also Episode 1 was Episode 1, so it lost a ton of money. And I'm seeing some eerie parallels between that and this.
Yeah, so real quick, thank you to VR Cryptid for the 6-month resub. VR Cryptid says, Rats Wars.
Rats Wars.
Can't say I disagree.
Rats and Wars.
So let's get started.
Okay, it's October 28th, 1998. I'm sorry, I stepped all over you.
Go ahead. It's okay. So I just want to say a couple of these games were not going, the first couple of three of these games, we won't be playing the full versions, just the demos, because the demos, I think, give a nice, clear, concise beginning, middle, and end. So it's easier to look through them. So they're not really representative of the full games, but yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay, so first up is the first game released. It's October 28th, 1998. Star Wars Episode One Mania is starting to sweep the nation. Everyone's getting really excited. You see those Pepsi cans, those vending machines. But this isn't about that.
Those pizza boxes with Jar Jar on them.
Oh my God, do you remember those?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you showed me one earlier today. So first off, we're playing Star Wars DroidWorks. So let's get this started here.
Let's work them droids.
Mm-hmm.
So 98, this is slightly before Episode One, mm-hmm. but during the marketing blitz, mm-hmm. I assume.
This was absolutely during the marketing blitz.
Do you have the game screen on?
Yes.
Okay, good.
It should be.
Wow, look at all those Star Wars games.
Oh yeah, we're playing through all of them, so get used to it.
There's so fucking many of them. Huh. Ah, there's our buddies. C-3PO, R2-D2, the nameless Ewoks. Those aren't Ewoks. Those are, save me, someone.
I didn't see it. Jawas?
Jawas, there you go.
Okay, folks, this is, again, we're new mic setup, new audio setup. Let me know if the audio is too loud or too quiet for the game, because...
Can you turn it down a little bit on our end?
Yeah, I was going to say, it's kind Thank of blazing you. Droid noises at us.
Lots to keep track of. Do Jawas support Java? You know, they did, but then all those Trojans and backdoors got developed, and now they don't support it anymore, at least not officially.
All right, let me just bump it. Okay. So, my name is, of course, let's see. This is before the prequels, so... There.
Nice.
It's in canon.
Here we go, folks.
So this is an educational game. Keep that in mind.
Okay. Pretty good looking zoom there.
The fight for freedom in the galaxy continues.
Oh, he reads it.
Rebel spies have learned that the evil Empire has built a hidden droid factory somewhere on the planet Tatooine.
No!
It is there that Imperial engineers are building an army of assassin droids. Once completed, these dangerous machines
will
terrorize the galaxy. The Rebel Alliance must find this secret factory and reprogram the assassin droids. To accomplish this mission, the Rebel leaders have selected one of their most trusted agents.
Note, because of size restrictions, you can only play this for 3 minutes.
I wish that the special edition had a thing that said, note, we have added additional footage, or whatever.
Note, we've taken out Jar Jar. Quit complaining.
Okay, so again, this is a demo version. So we're not going to see Wimatika's workshop interface, da-da-da-da-da. That's fine.
Okay.
So, in DroidWorks, first of all, let me put a name in. We're making a droid.
Oh.
So, what would you name your droid if you could name them anything, Danny? Because I'm just going to put in gay rats. I want to give you some input.
Okay. It will be C3D2.
I thought you were going to go C420 or something.
No, it's their bastard child.
Okay. That is horrible. So... Again, this is an educational game, and my issue with this game is, aside from lateral learning skills, it's not very directly educational, and that's kind of a theme of these games, aside from one of them. They're educational, kind of in a vague... The earlier games are educational in a very vague sense of what it means to be educational.
I see C69PO. Mm-hmm. I see C6P9. Steve would have been a good bot name. R4TGay.
Love it.
All excellent choices, all much better than what I suggested.
So one thing about this, the point of this game is to build a droid and to make it complete, build a droid to complete a specific goal. Here's our goal. We need to pass through a security guard. It needs to be able to grab and tug, have a very strong arm, and communicate.
I'm sorry, what kind of robot are we building here?
Don't worry about it.
Okay. All right.
So it needs to communicate. So let's see.
Yeah, it's pointed out that it's not necessarily educational in a traditional sense, but it's educational about Star Wars. It teaches you how to consume Star Wars media.
It does. But I actually kind of like the way these games are educational because it's more about literal learning, like figuring out how to put things together and using... It's critical thinking skills comparative All to, right. say, I'm doing math with, like, I don't know, Jabba the Hutt or something.
Okay, that gives you a lot of leeway, actually. You can just say general thinking skills. It makes you think about stuff. Anyway, here's a bunch of robots.
Okay, so first
I gotta quit calling them robots. I'm sorry to everyone offended by that.
They're
droids, not robots.
Listen, in the series, there's even a droids rights movement. So anyway, so here are the heads we have.
Thank you to ArpaGa for the 16 months. Thinking is important. I agree. Thank you. Okay, give it the wedge-shaped head on the right.
This one? I was thinking that. So you know what? I'll let you choose. So we got this head.
It looks like Boba Fett's iron.
So this guy cannot communicate with words. It can only communicate with beeps. So that may not be good for us, but you know what? Let's go for it. This one's got a medium battery capacity, a heavily reinforced torso. This one's got medium. It's a female style protocol
boy.
Torso.
Did we really have to do that?
Can I? And then we've got, of course, the traditional one. They all feature medium battery. So let me grab a
droids, or as we like to call them, roids.
I was gonna say the gendered. Why would you gender the droids? Anyways, let's get some batteries here. Put in medium battery.
I have a feeling I know why that's the case.
Oh.
That's not exploring any of the movies there.
All right, we put in a battery pack because it can't move without a battery. And let's give it some legs. We've got these, which are high-speed reinforced bipedal locomotion. They can walk, jump, and run. And
traditional
these...
female-style reinforced droid.
Oh, my God. And this is bipedal locomotion, same thing. Very low power usage, which is good. We don't use a lot of power when we move. Also, I like this because... it reminds me of one of the droids at Star Tours where they just took one of the goose animatronics and stripped it, and now there's a droid with weird duck feet. So I like it.
It sort of reminds me how they'll put, like, little breastbones on the skeletons so you know it's a girl skeleton.
Yeah, it's weird.
Also, Juan, yes, stay tuned. There will be Elmo eventually.
All right.
2021 is the year of the Elmo.
Putting on some strong arms on our sexy droid here.
Okay, good.
Hubba hubba, yeah, sure. Okay, the arms are installed, and now we need a good tool. This one can grab and tug, and this one can also grab and tug. So I'm gonna get these beautiful
droids things. Are less sophisticated than I thought they were.
Well,
there's,
I
like,
mean,
universal translators, there's, like...
I'm gonna do one of each.
Those that specialize in ship repair, all these dudes are grab and tug.
Look at this sexy robot. Beautiful. I don't know what this does. Oh, I can test them, huh? Oh, look at them go!
Oh, nice! It walks on its own.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, I love its walk cycle. It's so good. Listen, please stop talking about...
Oh, man! Yes!
Oh, my God!
Yes!
Hey, this song!
Is there a speaker on the robot, and does this song play from it while it does this? Because that's really important.
What is this song?
I think this was featured in Kinect Star Wars.
This is... Look how...
This droid knows how to party.
She is hot stuff!
You know those 70s robots that held, like, drink trays? I think we just made one of those, only this one also tugs.
Yes, it's like Miko or Mako or whatever. I don't... Do I need to stop? Because I don't want to.
I don't want to either. I think you already made the best droid possible.
All right. Let's get to the meat of the game and the part that I can't get past.
Happy birthday, Polly. Oh, man. I'm won over. I like this game. I don't care if I'm not learning anything. It had the best thing I've ever seen.
I mean, we're learning how to solve problems in the general video game sense.
Hello, Cambertian. Yep, you can leave right now because that's the highlight of the stream. We haven't even seen Jar Jar yet. It's the perfect stream so far.
It is time to grind out another mission. To complete this training mission, your droid needs to reach the top of the cliff. Find a way to operate the bridge so it moves up or down to help your droid reach the top. Speaking of gears, check with Index for a better understanding of how they work. If you complete this mission, you'll be awarded the ranking of apprentice and rewarded with a Cybot Galactica 9P standard protocol torso.
All right, we get a new torso if we do this, and I have a secret. I could not get past this. I tried so hard, so many times. And
rise and grind, gamers.
It was impenetrable to me. But this area is pretty cool, and also we have, like...
You're on your way to the top. Mm-hmm. Find a way to operate the bridge so it moves up or down. Then use it to get your droid to the top of the cliff. My scanners detect some objects in the area that might be helpful. Understanding how gears work is essential. My data circuits have worked in high gear and confirm that Index has lots of information on gears. Just press the blinking Index button below.
Okay,
is that droid Southern or about to cry or both? Because it sounded like it was in distress.
It did. So
I've got the droid vapors.
This has a very a lot. This is a lot of stuff to do. Space bar, look up, look down, center view. You got your left and your right arm.
This is way too much for a kid. This is too much for me.
That's what I mean.
I can barely handle two analog sticks, much less.
Yeah, I just... Ugh, boy. Okay.
Yeah, it's a 3D game. I didn't even know that up until this point. Thank you to Rio Dice for the 500 bits.
Oh, man.
Thank you for the
Dilithium
crystals. A crucial part of the Star Wars universe. Thank you. Much appreciated.
So, there we go. I what I love here is, I'm sorry, the delightful little skip.
It's so happy.
It is. It's having a good time.
Why wouldn't you make a droid that skips?
You see, like, that's why it's like, oh, the Skywalker family, they made a bunch of droids and they repaired droids, but their droids are just, they don't, C-3PO doesn't skip.
Hey, this is more than 3 FPS. This is at least 7 or 8.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit smoother than Virtual Hydlide, but Virtual Hydlide didn't simulate your own custom droid, so checkmate.
Okay, so it seems pretty clear our objective is to find a gear and put it in a thing and make the bridge go do what it needs to do. That's a great description.
Make it go do the thing, yeah.
Yes.
This reminds me of Shadows of the Empire, at least in terms of setting. The texturing is a little bit better.
This, if I recall, this does have the, it's either Shadows of the Empire or another game, but it does feature the same engine. Chad, if you know if this is what engine this is, please let me know. But yeah, it's one of the...
And if you know the key command for pulling out a lightsaber and going completely apeshit, let us know. Please tell me that's a thing.
No, you can't do that in this one. This isn't like Yoda stories.
Just make it blare out that droid disco while it just slices up everybody.
Okay, we're doing good. As long as I don't fall off the edge, we're good. Good.
Oh, that is true. Virtual Hydlight did have a custom gym simulation. You could customize your gym.
You could. All right, doing good.
This might be the Jedi engine. They were making a whole bunch of 3D Star Wars games at this point. More traditional ones for adults. I mean, general audiences, not porno games, is what I'm trying to say.
I need the gear. Okay, as long as I don't fall off, I'm good. So we got a problem.
Yeah.
My power is low.
Oh no, and you have to walk uphill.
Mm-hmm. Luckily, these things will move you automatically. So I put them on and... Whoop.
Moby Games says Sith. Is that the engine?
Yeah, I guess.
There's no such thing as Star Wars porno. Please don't look it up.
Don't, please. My hands are full with this naughty little droid who's...
At least there's conveyor belts now. That helps.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there's no way I'm going to do this. So, luckily, I am going to... If I can't find the gear within a few minutes, I'm just going to move on. But, yeah, this is a really interesting game. You make a droid, and you put it through its paces, and...
There weren't many games back then that let you fully customize your character in a 3D world. It was usually well established what your character could and couldn't do. So in some ways, this is ambitious. In other ways... Oh, no. Okay, I thought the conveyor belt was running downhill.
No!
Are you doing a speedrunning trick?
No.
You're gonna
apparently
go hyper speed?
I am. Okay, I made it. I actually thought I was going to fall there.
I've seen some of those Jedi Knight speedruns where they just kind of fling themselves across the map. Yeah, you use the Force. That's what happened.
This is not the gear. Okay, that's fine. I'm normal. Feeling normal.
I don't know. Your energy's not looking too good.
It's fine. Let's just go up a couple more levels.
I guess it's a combination of Jedi Knight and Chibi Robo then, huh? You gotta go plug yourself into the wall.
Bad news, the conveyor belt's off.
Uh-oh. It's gonna be a long walk up.
No, it's fine.
Yes, Razor Vermilion, we updated our mics.
No,
It took a really long time.
No!
Oh boy. Rest in peace to a real one.
Hey, it could grab and tug, though. It could grab and tug.
It tugged like nobody's business. Unfortunately, the whole walking thing didn't work out nearly as well. Yeah, we're upgrading. It's going to sound weird, especially if you're used to the exact same sound we've been delivering for the last 5 years.
I
am, so it sounds completely weird to me, too.
What options does this game have? Okay. I think we're going to quit, though.
Why is C-3PO in kryptonite?
Oh.
I mean, You know what I mean.
Carbonite.
Carbonite. Thank you.
Hold on. One final jam.
I don't sound professional. You take that back.
All right. Good stuff. So that's DroidWorks.
Okay. I have worked on the droids, and, well, I've discovered that they're all about disco. I've discovered they're all about grabbing and tugging things.
Mm-hmm.
I was hoping for it to be more educational because, you know, I'm all about that. But while I didn't learn anything, I had a good time.
All right. Next one is, so it's now May 24th, 1999. And guess what? It's episode one time. From here on out, I hope you like Jar Jar.
I love him. Can't get enough of him. Thank you, itinerant soldier. That's what I'm looking for. Well, episode one is out, and thus comes the marketing blitz. A lot of these games, for whatever reason, focus on the star of the show, the person George Lucas himself thought would carry the entire prequel trilogy, your friend and mine, Jar Jar Binks.
So, our next game is Star Wars The Gungan Frontier. This one is, it's basically Sim Earth in a lot of ways, but kind of better? Sim Earth stands. I actually really liked this game when I played it, so I'm kind of excited to show it off.
You kind of really built that up in not so many words. That's like Sim Earth, only it's not a piece of shit.
That's not fair. I just couldn't get into Sim Earth, but I got into this.
There's a lot to Sim Earth.
So the interesting thing about these games is the more games there are, the more Jar Jar you see. First game, barely any Jar, no Jar Jar. This game also, while it features the Gungan society, it doesn't feature any Jar Jar himself. Jar Jar is not in this.
Okay, so we get to learn about his people.
Mm-hmm.
If you'll remember, in case it's been a while since you've seen episode one, the Gungans live underwater. Is that true in this game as well?
Yes. In fact, what you're doing is you're repopulating a planet, a moon in particular, for the Gungans to live on.
Okay.
The game will go through the whole thing. It's pretty nice, but,
create a critter!
You can't do that in the demo, unfortunately.
No!
I know, but we have 8 games to go through.
Okay, fair.
And some of them are storybooks. We have a lot, so let's
go. Is this Gungan mule? That would rule.
Kind of! So let's get started on the demo mission. I may need to turn this up, though.
Welcome to the moon of Naboo.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to need to release plants, tell Gungans whether how much they can or can't harvest, and bring the population up to 2,000.
Oh, it's just like you said. It's a world-building simulation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Opa Gungan style.
Your mission is to release creatures and plants, build a balanced ecosystem, and help the Gungans build a new city.
Is that supposed to be Sam Jackson-like?
It sounds like it.
Click the main menu button at any time.
Got it.
Look in the upper right-hand corner of the screen.
Ooh.
Notice that your bio score and the number of Gungans are currently at 0.
Oh, no.
I don't believe in biorhythms.
Where should we begin? Releasing some plants is a good place to start building an ecosystem. Move your cursor toward the center of the screen.
Got it.
Notice that your cursor is carrying a bubble spore. Click the mouse button to release a bubble spore.
Wait, did he say Gungan? Is that the official pronunciation?
No.
Good job.
Okay.
The bubble spore is released from your ship and arrives at the point you indicated. The plant fizzes in as the probe droid detects it and transmits the data to your holoviewer.
That's lore.
Try releasing some more bubble spore.
This is the most laid-back Samuel Jackson impersonator I've ever heard in my life. There's not nearly enough screaming.
Okay, so in this one we only got 6 creatures, 4 plants,
now,
that's fine.
Now, let's release an animal. Click on the species indicator. Clicking on the species indicator opens the food web. The food web shows you what eats what and lets you choose different plants and animals.
God.
The animals above the bubble spore all like to eat this strange plant. Click on the kudu. Good. The kudu can eat all the plants that appear below it.
Okay.
What do you think the fearsome beasts above the kudu all have in common?
They get eaten by it?
Kudu.
Oh, they're predators. See, yeah, again,
oh,
this,
they're predators.
This
okay.
one feels Click more on educational kudu. In a Maxis type way. So this one I would definitely say you could learn at least some basics. Of...
Yeah, but it's still all fake creatures. So.
I know, right? Like...
Now release some kudu. Excellent, my young friend. We need about 20 kudu on the moon before we can continue.
Oh, that's a tall order. Tony could do.
Surprised at some other plants.
Or maybe not. Maybe it's not a tall order at all. Maybe Alex can do it in like 2 seconds. There you
Notice
go.
Notice that the Gungan population is still at zero.
Yeah, 23 could do.
Remember that your goal is to help the Gungans create a new underwater city on this moon.
Okay.
Click on the harvest button. The Gungans need animals and plants for food and construction in their city.
Smebel says that Jar Jar is your advisor in the full version.
How much of the species they can use in their
new
city.
Oh my god.
I want
that. The
more
they harvest, the bigger the city will get.
Okay, I do too.
But be careful. If you let them take too much, they'll destroy the delicate balance and everyone will suffer.
Nice.
Harvest rate a lot.
Right now, the harvest rate of Kadu is set to none.
No, I want it to be maintained.
The Gungans won't harvest. The Gungans will now try. This should cause the Gungan population to grow slowly for a while.
Okay. So,
Now click on the harvest button to close the harvest screen.
Button.
Oh. I know how to use this kid's game.
This is seeming a little bit more like Oregon Trail.
Population
oh, and more towards Origins.
Mm-hmm.
Now, click on the city button to see how the Gungan city is doing.
Yeah, how y'all doing down
there? The city will grow and shrink depending on what and how much is harvested. Information about the Gungan city appears in the upper right of the holo view. Buildings will disappear and Gungans will move out if not enough raw materials are harvested.
You said Gungans that
Boss
time.
Boss Nass will let you know how the Gungan city is doing and if you need to harvest more plants and
Big
animals.
One. Pick a pronunciation.
No, let me, I got it. Okay.
Apparently it's hotly contested in the real world too, as Arnold
Rimmer
points out.
You are almost done with the training mission. Just
maybe there isn't a correct
thing.
Pronunciation.
To make the menu bar appear, this makes the menu bar appear.
Got it.
You can control many things from the menu bar. Click on the help menu and turn on bubble help.
Where's bubble help?
Click on the help menu and turn on bubble help.
I'm a child here.
Now
hold
move
on.
Your cursor around.
This is essentially proto Spore. Spore was a lot more built out in some ways.
And let's
Words
go.
Pop up
but it didn't have any Gungans in it or Gungans.
This can be handy when you're learning how to play.
Got
Clicking
it.
On anything will turn bubble help off.
The speech-to-text picked up both ways I pronounced Gungans, so thank you.
Earlier, it picked up Wikipedia and then corrected it to Wikipedia.
Oh, come on.
I'm like, no, you got it right the first time. So what I'm going to do is see how fast I can mess this up. So let's put in...
Okay. Ruin the ecosystem.
All right, got to put some stuff in the mud. So we got that.
That's one of John Williams' lesser known pieces.
It's one of his best. Let's add some of these shacks.
What everyone, what's your favorite John Williams piece? Mine is All
right, let's add a bunch of these. Doing good. Gungan's doing good. Let's add more. More, 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 more.
I pronounce both correctly every time. The text to speech recognizes this.
This is good. This is good. That's good, right? Okay, do you think we have enough for predators?
Yeah.
Okay.
Put some T-Rexes in this.
Let's add a Veermock.
No, T-Rexes.
I don't have a... Okay. Let's add a T-Rex.
Thank you. Yeah, John Williams did One Winged Angel. That's a good one.
And let's... Good luck, everybody. You're gonna need it.
Survival of the fittest.
That
Here
a
we
lot.
Go.
Let's add too many.
Oh boy.
It's fine. It's a good bio score.
Jar Jar's never gonna settle here.
Jar Jar superstar.
Misa think fuck this is what he's gonna say.
You know what? I think we need more and I think we need more things. I think we need to ruin the frame rate even
The performance
more.
Is suffering.
Good.
Yeah, there's some blomby creatures in here. That's
so,
a blomby world
can
we're
I
creating.
Disasters? Critter escape, disease, moonquake, pollution spill, probe droid malfunction!
There we go.
Where can I... Oh, it won't let me do it. Darn.
All
yeah.
the Tuggan robots have gone nuts.
I think we're going to do a full playthrough of this later, but my goal is to just get the Gungans to do what they need to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Harvest, and you know what? A lot.
Yeah.
Go nuts.
Mm-hmm.
Just go crazy.
Take all the resources you need. We'll make more.
I thought this was... Okay, I actually ended up... I was trying to do an intentionally bad job so I'd lose. But no, I did it! We did it!
Hey, nice work.
Mm-hmm. So this is a super interesting game. Again, as Danny said, kind of a mix of Sim-Earth and Spore. And I guess the full game has way more Jar Jar, but in this version, not Jar Jar-esque at all, aside from the creatures being there, so I appreciate that.
I love that they put the Gungan leader at the absolute top of the box, everyone's favorite character.
Everyone loves Boss Nass. Are you anti-Boss Nass, honey?
You know his name.
Of course I do. Listen, I decided to spend a good portion of the last few months in quarantine, last month in quarantine, learning about this because I literally watched one video about Darth Vader's suit helping him poop and it made me obsessed. Thank you. So that's Gungan.
I think you mean inspired. Gungan Frontier. At some point I would like to see the full version considering all the bonus Jar Jar content.
Oh, I just want to say that you can get this game by calling 1-800-TRUE-FAN. Just reflect on that for a bit.
That's true. Are you a true fan? Only true fans can call this 800 number.
So that was a pretty short look at Gungan Frontier. The next game, we are going to be taking a long look at and trying to play through as many of this as possible.
It's August 17th, 1999, and we are going to take the Yoda Challenge. Everyone know what the Yoda Challenge is?
That sounds dangerous. So one interesting thing about this game in particular is that this is a much more traditional, it's much more of a educational game. It is just straight up a game for little children. This is, if you're playing this as an adult, you're either, I don't know, you're a streamer. You have
lots
to be a streamer.
Lots of good theories about what the Yoda Challenge is. I think it's all of those at the same time. So have fun.
All right. I kind of love this game.
For parents? The for parents?
Oh, I have to put in the disc. The for parents section, I'm not showing this to chat, but the for parents section of the Lucas learning thing is just, it's basically install, uninstall,
DirectX. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, kids don't need to learn about DirectX.
Okay, but let me, hold on one sec, let me put in the game.
Ugh, remember updating DirectX, and then it would break everything?
Yes, I actually do, because I have to do that anytime I install a game.
Oh man, the nightmare never ended for Alex.
All right, here we go. It's time for the Yoda Challenge.
Weird Al hadn't seen The Phantom Menace when he wrote his parody? Wow. I don't know what to think about that. Maybe he's just a genius.
He is. 1-800-TRUE-FAN is experiencing technical difficulties. Beautiful.
Did you try calling it? At least it's not a sex number.
The Yoda Challenge is staying in the pit for 100 years. That is why Yoddle is my favorite Star Wars character.
I wonder who made that file.
Don't worry about it. Yes, I need to remove Gay Rat Kenobi.
No.
So this is Yoda's challenge. Let's put a new player. Danny, I always name these. Give me an in-universe Star Wars name.
Yodel.
Yoddle and Yoda's cousin.
Uh-huh.
Oh, they suck.
Are you sensing a theme to the names I'm suggesting?
Yes.
My fanon is everyone has kids. The droids, the weird Muppets, the humans.
You're right. Yoddle is theologically challenging to consider.
Yoddle is Yoda's cousin from the Alps.
Thank you, Hexagon Witch, for the 16-month resub. Now this is pod racing.
This is pod racing. Thank you.
The Trade Federation blockade has been destroyed.
I laughed when I heard that line last time we watched it. It was really funny.
Queen Amidala has returned to her people in triumph. The cost of victory was great.
This narrator gets a lot of work, especially on kids' stuff.
Perished in the final battle.
Next on Cartoon Network, Dexter is fucking around in his lab or some shit. Oops, I'm fired. Tom Kane, yes. Gets a lot of work. Dude gets around.
So this is a full game, so we gotta get the whole experience. And this has an entirely different art style. And notice this art style because the rest of these games, aside from two of them, ones we won't be playing, feature this very unique, not used in a lot of other places in Star Wars merch art style.
Okay, so it's a little bit different than what you may be used to.
Very multimedia, late 90s aesthetic. And look at him!
Oh, no.
The Palace of the Jedi. Brave you must be. A great challenge have you.
Holy crap, Lois.
I don't know why.
Six missions there are.
It looks exactly like a Family Guy.
Your skill they will test. Deadly droids. Destroying the sacred forest of Naboo they are.
Oh no.
Queen Amidala's royal starship. Your help the queen will need. C-3PO, Anakin's droid. To him, knowledge of the Jedi you must bring. The Gungan caves. Find the hidden places and unlock secret doors you must.
Create he does look like Grover, you're right.
For Anakin, yes. With you, I will always
Seth McForce.
Choose and begin.
All right, so this features six different mini games.
Are you sure this isn't a fan parody? You pulled off a new ground.
Oh no, this is
why
not.
Does he look over there? Oh, that's so good. This is my new favorite depiction of Yoda in any media.
Do you think anything's gonna happen if I click him?
Click him right on the face. I can't deal with this. I can't. No, that's that weird, pleased smirk.
This is so good. So do you want me to do the best one first or save it for last?
Let's save the best for last.
Okay, so let's do this in count. Let's do this in clockwise order. Then we'll start the race at feed.
I think all of this is the best part.
Quietly have you chosen?
This is real. No, this
our
is real.
Bedroom eyes. Half mask Yoda, they call him.
One on Naboo. A his celebration eyes. There is.
So these are all just
Queen Amidala,
mini games for children. Jar Jar, and here he is, the friends. Man himself, Jar Jar. Yeah.
This art style is
four
completely unexpected to me.
10 races in each
oh,
level.
Damn, Tom Kane is
enjoy
doing,
racing,
the
Queen and Jar Jar do. Yes.
Holy crap.
Wow.
The Queen sometimes
he's versatile. Holy crap,
Louis. In Tuscat she rides. Swift it is in forest and on hills. Sometimes
so he's
Jar
giving
Jar,
a very long explanation.
He rides.
Seems today that all you see is violence among Gungans and tugging droids on TV.
No.
To begin, click on the circle that glows.
Okay, so basically what I talked over is we got a race between Jar Jar and Amidala. Each of these creatures handles environments better, and some creatures handle the environment better than others. So Padme's mount can handle forests, while Jar Jar's mount's better in swamps. You have to choose what route they go on, and
begin,
this time I have to have
the circle
Padme
that glows.
So
I didn't even notice the tiny Yoda down there.
He's been talking this entire
mission,
time.
Return to the palace.
I can click on
Jedi
him for help, but I refuse to click on that nasty man's face.
Both riders look ready to go.
Okay,
they're on
so
the line,
I have to basically choose the best route for my racer. So
that was Tom Kane too. Does he do every voice in this?
He's getting a lot of money.
I hope he got paid a lot of
Queen
money.
Queen Amidala is picking up speed as she rides her Tuscat through the forest.
And
oh, someone got bogged down in the forest. Did you win?
I won.
Good work.
So you can change the levels too. You can do an easier one.
You're quite talented. Where did you learn to race?
Well, this is a game for children, and I'm 37, so. Okay, so this goes on. You can do different levels. Let's do the hardest level and see what that's like. And then move on.
Swear on my profile, please do not.
Okay, so we're playing as Padme this time. Padme's creature does not do well in water, so we're going to try to go up this way. And oh boy,
now this is what I'd more expect from kids games. This is very
not
straightforward.
Not everyone in the galaxy gets to race like this.
That's true.
The things that it teaches you are pretty obvious, just pathfinding.
We're about ready here as the racers are at the starting line.
Nowadays these kids just use Google Maps and they'll drive through a freaking lake to get to Walmart or whatever.
Neck and neck as they start
I did not mean to.
They're neck and neck. Whoever makes the best decision for the last time.
I didn't know Yoda ran a Christian Minecraft server.
Oh no.
Go.
Sorry, I didn't click
go,
in time.
Go. Don't lose to Jar Jar.
Stop it! I'm going to be nice about me losing to Jar Jar. Is this the hardest level? I lost to Jar Jar.
Who knew what that Kadoo could do? Whoa, the Queen took the long way that time. I'm sure she'll look for shorter paths in her next race.
I should have gone up. That was that.
I've never seen Jar Jar move that fast.
That's right. Oh boy, so that was my bad.
Jar Jar was booking it.
I lost, but that's basically it. You choose the routes, they can handle different terrains easier than others.
Yeah, Jar Jar's the queen now,
race.
That's how it works.
Mm-hmm. And if you get to play as Jar Jar, Jar Jar says cute things to you, you know, it's...
Cute.
He says Jar Jar things. We got six of these to go through, so this is going to be pretty fast. Next is Trap Droids.
I will never ever get over that Yoda as long as I live.
This?
No, stop. It's too early. It's too early for bedroomized Yoda.
All right, this one's a little more complicated. This is a very basic
Many dangerous droids remain on the move, destroying the sacred forest they are.
They're deforesting.
Mm-hmm. So we gotta stop these guys.
Help Jar Jar trap the droids. This is your mission. 4 droid traps there are. A special drumbeat triggers each trap. Jar Jar plays the drumbeat. Then you must play it on the drums.
It's like patapon.
Listen to the rhythm of the music. Play the drums in time with the music, or catch the droids you will not. Very important it is to play the drums exactly the way Jar Jar does. The droids are coming. This shows how many, yes. The number of colored droids. Jar Jar needs you to trap this many. Crossed
I love
off
that he talks like Yoda.
Trap it.
He makes a good teacher, though.
Does when
mm-hmm.
a droid gets well, away.
He's very famous for that.
Yeah, true.
Droid you can. Most difficult is the red. Begin with the green, yes. The circle that glows. Click on it to begin.
Yes, we're the Patapon Padawan.
Okay, there is a way to turn on subtitles for Yoda. I'm going to do that after this game. I completely blanked on doing that. But actually, that's one nice thing I like about some of these games is that they offer subtitles for the characters, something a lot of early multimedia games did not do.
That is forward thinking,
sucks.
Yeah. Rhythm right. take you the over. By Lumos, it does.
Click on it.
I like this party boy Yoda. who knows what rhythm is.
This is released May 1999.
Tap use of fingers with the beat.
Was I off beat?
Try tapping footin' with the beat.
Am I really that off beat? I was
that sounded good to me.
This earlier.
Try being better. Oh, you did it. Look at him go.
Jar Jar telling me to do better is just so insulting.
The trick is to march, keep on marching.
That is a trick.
There's a little bit of input lag, I can tell.
Just with the drum just right.
And yes, thank you, Codeman. That is Ahmed Best, the voice of Jar Jar, doing
the original
here.
Himself.
Yeah.
Nice.
We said trying to match in the beat.
Jar Jar!
That's so frustrating. Being told off by Jar Jar.
Get out of here.
Ooh,
this
yeah.
is great!
Alright, two more
Yusa
to go.
Yusa and Misa mm-hmm. make terrific teamings.
Yes, Ebit, this is essentially Patapon. Or as someone mentioned earlier, with the Patapon Padawans. That's so good.
How to keep beat?
I guess
that's educational.
Wahoo!
And I think this is it. All right, you
should feel a happy face because Yusa did this, eh?
Thank you, Jar Jar.
Yeah.
Yusa doing it. We should do some more.
So,
Jar Jar also had the bedroom eyes, I'm sorry to say.
Unfortunately, you cannot escape that in these games.
We should do it some more, he said.
Okay, I'm going to turn on the subtitles.
If you must, but finish what you begin and return another day.
I will. I'm just turning on subtitles, dude. No reason to get so dramatic.
Hey, don't ban me. I'm just saying what's going on.
Hey, can anyone time travel back to the 90s and make everyone add this for their multimedia games, because oh my god, makes a huge difference. So let's keep going. That's yodel.
Yodel, yeah. He did sound a little angry, didn't he?
Yeah, clingy that, Yoda is.
That's after many hours in the recording booth. Fine, fucking say the lines, I will.
Like, you don't want me to quit now because you are going to lose your mind at the last game. No, Yoda. See, returns you have.
Much remains to be done, yes.
50 years from now, I'm going to be looking at that Yoda and just uncontrollably laughing.
Deadly droids.
Yeah,
destroying
I
the sacred.
I finally found what my sense
are.
Of humor is, and it's horrible.
Yoda, I know what they are.
Queen
yeah, Yoda Lehi Hu.
Valuable pictures disappeared they have. To find them, that your mission is.
Oops. Misa caused a little bitty accidente and crashing the Queen's mechanique.
I'm glad
aboard,
we have subtitles.
Blue Royal Starship. I hope you will help us.
Any help here would be hot.
So, Jar Jar, more Jar Jar here. Jar Jar
in each circle,
up the
a picture is hidden. Four sets of pictures there are. Most difficult to uncover are the red ones.
Yes.
Green is a good place to begin. Yes. To begin, click on the circle you must.
Got it. So, spoilers, it's tanagrams.
Uncover the hidden picture.
I'll do one and
move
then I'm moving on. Do not make me do tanagrams.
Spot,
I love tangrams. Let's do nothing but tangrams.
Do you really love tangrams?
I do.
Okay, well then you're going to love
grab
this.
Grab the corners you must. When all are in place, the hidden picture will appear. Yes. Back to the other pictures. Yes.
All right, let's hear it from the fans of the Game Boy classic Didalian Opus. This is clearly based on that. We got any Didalian Opus fans out there? My tongue refuses to say that word.
It's the new mic setup. It's
how about fans of Hayankyo Alien? Let's hear it for Hayankyo Alien. Boy, I wish Jar Jar was in Hayankyo Alien.
God, don't we all?
I'd bury the shit out of him.
I'm sorry, I'm just...
Oh, we do have some Didalian Opus fans. Good. Got a good crowd here.
Service to me and my crew.
Opus is dopus.
It will be commended. And you can, if you want, you can print this out. And you get a lot of info about the pod racer. It is a pod racer.
That's Anakin's pod racer. He built it himself.
Oh.
You have done well. Take this path. Print the picture you will. To uncover this picture once more, choose this path. Yes. Take this path. More hidden pictures will you find.
I'm sorry. Just the way he talks about printing is killing me.
Yeah, and it's still all in Yoda speak, so it's kind of like backwards. All
right, so there's a lot of those. There's tangrams, so, you know, if you want tanagrams with Jar Jar Binks, Danny.
Didalian Opus, but with cats. My God. I must research this. Thank you for
on
telling
Tatooine
me about it.
On Tatooine is Anakin's droid, C-3PO. He must learn the stories of Obi-Wan and other strong
oh, yeah, it's
with
fucked up
Force.
Naked C-3PO.
I don't like it. Technically, he's just 3PO, not C-3PO here, but fine.
In each box, a story sent by Anakin.
Is that true?
Four sets of stories.
Did he only gain the
are.
C in the
to C-3PO
episodes 4, 5, yeah. and 6?
The
red
I just,
boxes.
I think
the most
so. I don't know. Someone will correct
begin with
me.
The green. This is good. Many
he is wearing a diaper.
No, that's what I was begin. Thinking. Thank you for saying it.
He's wearing a nice ceramic diaper.
All right. Anakin tells... So we can do the harder levels, but this one is
yeah, let's
weird.
Start there.
Yes, and he tells
you do well. In each story, four pages there are. Yes. Tell a story you can. Move the words into the right boxes.
Anakin was
back
sad.
To the other stories this path leads. Tell the story you can. Ready you are.
Yes, yes, Yoda, I am ready.
Ready you are.
So basically, you look at the things here.
I don't mean to intrude, but don't forget to drag the word you've chosen to the shapes above.
Did they get Tony was. Daniels for this?
Sad.
Sorry, Anthony Daniels.
Anakin was sad.
Oh, it's all. It is confirmed. That is his original
that
voice actor. Nice.
Asked.
Spared no expense.
Him. What. Was. Wrong.
Wrong.
Padme asked him what was wrong.
Yeah, Tony Danza. Amazing. He heard tell the two truth wanted.
So I don't know what this is teaching children.
Parts of sentences. It's doing it kind of clumsily and ham-fistedly, but that's what kindergarten's for.
Okay. This is so...
Truth.
Yeah, the celebratory sound effects are really harsh. Okay, last page. Don't fuck it up.
I. Miss.
Oh my
miss.
God. Are we really going into this?
Yes.
Look, we all know it's incredibly fucked up
he
that Anakin was freed from slavery, but not his mother.
I miss my mother.
Yeah, that's actually.
But
that's,
you don't gotta put it in your children's. Oh my god.
I asked him what was wrong. He wanted to tell her the truth. I miss my mother, he said. If I may venture an opinion.
You may not.
Anakin's honesty is very heartwarming.
You do well. If you want to print the story, take this path you can. To tell this story again, choose this path. Yes. Tell C-3PO another of Anakin's stories you can. This path must you take.
You must.
This my
You gotta do at least one more.
Do you want to do one more?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, how we...
Yeah, the pod race.
Okay,
pod race,
okay.
Pod race.
You cannot make me do the hard one.
Anakin wanted...
Anakin wanted Anakin to Anakin
to
pod race Anakin.
Win. Pod race.
Oh, doing it out of order. Speedrun stuff.
I am trying to speedrun this
Anakin shit. Anakin wanted to win the pod race.
Alright.
He...
Well, you say the prequels weren't really kids' movies, but George Lucas really, really, really wanted them to be kids' movies, in spite of all the talk about taxation and trade routes or whatever.
You can really tell in episode one, and it's why this was made. Hey. Star Wars? It was... He had never finished a...
Race.
Oh, I, okay, race. I didn't know.
Oh, there's a dud word in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, that's what I got. It.
Trying to trick you. Yeah, someone gets cut in half.
Never
but it's like, I'll just put it this way. A lot of Lucasfilm's income was from merchandising over the years and helped them fund a lot of things. And they didn't really capitalize on the initial release of Star Wars on the merchandising as much as they did later.
Hold up, hold up. Put butt back. I want to hear him say
but,
it.
But.
There, nice and clear.
Good, thank you.
Oh
but,
boy, but
this but promise to tell this but
time he
had,
he had time to promise to keep his butt.
This is, they have such a
promise.
But yeah, one of the reasons for the big merchandising blitz was not just because it was, you know, making money, but they didn't do as much for the first film. They did a blitz, but not like this, and they wanted to really, really get that money.
Promise to keep.
And that's why there was all that shit. And
okay, last page. Probably plenty of duds in there.
Hold on.
I like how it provides basic outlines of the words. That's actually pretty helpful if you're only coming to grips with how the letters are shaped and how they fit together.
Two.
But then again, that's kind of a different year and different skill set.
His
learning what letters are shaped like and piecing together sentences. That's like the difference between kindergarten and second grade, probably,
you
right?
Down.
So, Phantom Menace was PG. It really, really was supposed to be a kid's film.
His new friends down. Anakin wanted to win the pod race. He had never finished a race before, but this time he had a promise to keep. He did not want to let his new friends down. It seems Anakin was willing to make a real commitment.
Yeah, that's what he said in the temple when he executed Order 66 on those children.
Wow, Alex.
I'm sorry.
I noticed that it said he didn't want to let his new friends down. That's because his old friends are actually seen in the movie and they're little shitheads.
They are.
They're like, hey, Annie, you're sure driving a real piece of shit. You're gonna die out there.
If you would give my regards to Yoda.
Kind of a messed up movie in a lot of ways.
It is. I kind of love it.
Speaking of messed up.
So this is a dungeon exploring game.
There's a
first person.
There's a Gungan dungeon crawler.
Yes.
Boy, try saying that five times fast. Don't. Gungan dungeon. Just rolling around that phrase in my head.
Gungeon. Wait, that's something.
Enter
else
the gungeon,
yes.
Valuable relics the Gungans locked behind these doors. Yes. Before the great battle of Naboo it was. Only gemstones open these doors. Deep inside the cave the gems lie. Your mission? Find the gems. Unlock these secret doors. To open a door, 10 gemstones it takes, yes. Be careful of the door you choose. Red is the most difficult, the Gungans say. The green door is a good place to begin. To begin, click on the glowing circle.
So each of these has 10 levels. I'm only doing a couple of the easy ones.
Okay, fair enough.
And when you get through it, all it does is open the door and a cool statue kind of comes out.
Well, now you ruined it.
Sorry, that's what happened. Sorry, spoilers.
Special sight you will need. Directions to the gemstones there are. The map shows
you weren't lying. This is definitely a first-person dungeon crawler.
Enter the cave.
So, 4-2 steps.
Oh, it tells you which way to go. That's nice.
I'm actually going to do one of the harder ones just to see if it actually removes this and makes it harder. And then you turn left.
Use caution. FOE, there is.
Striped lizard's nose. Bada boom. And there's your first gemstone.
That was easy.
A skilled explorer you are. Mm.
I hope this isn't Spider-Man's basement.
And there you go. That is,
The first of 10.
Yeah, we're not doing 10. I am going to try the hard level, though, just out of curiosity.
Okay.
See what's different.
Even in the Star Wars universe, FOE.
Oh. It tells you north and... Okay. So now I'm just wondering directions. This is kind of cool, actually.
Not far from here, your reward is...
You should have played this much earlier.
I agree, actually. South. I like this.
Yeah, Scarlet Swordfish, this is pretty cool, just in terms of the amount of content. It doesn't focus too much on any one thing. And yet they're all kind of built out with the same level of production quality. This looks good.
Okay, the spider on
it does
the
look
left
a little,
side of the door.
It looks a little SNES-ish, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, I was playing a real shitty dungeon crawler on Super Nintendo the other day. Anyone ever play Arcana? That's like if HAL Laboratory ripped off Shining in the Darkness. It's not very good.
Every spider looking at the top of the door. Oh, my God. So every spider that's facing a certain direction.
Yeah, teens playing Etrian Odyssey and being like, this is just
Yoda's
challenge. Counting
with care you are.
Oh, this is complicated. This must be the max difficulty.
Yeah, there's kind of a lot going on. Is anyone else looking up? Is that guy looking up?
Okay. Is Arcana pretty well regarded? Maybe it
there
just has a really slow start.
Oh my God, it's still going. Okay.
Keep it going. Make sure to bring your torch. You brought a torch, right? Okay, no, we're good.
It's fine.
Oh, I gotta play Shining the Holy Ark. That game actually looks great. Let me tell you the Shining games I like.
Okay.
In the Darkness.
Counting your steps
force.
With care you are.
That's it. Sorry. Okay. I only like two Shining games.
The circle between the wavy lines. I feel like a dumbass. I'm just gonna click on circles.
You're basically Indiana Jones. Circle below the wavy lines. What does that mean?
Oh, this one? There
oh,
we
go. Yeah, okay.
All the bunches of 4S.
I've tried many times to get into Shining Force 2 and it did not take. I cannot
great
tell you why.
You make, yes.
The gameplay is basically identical to 1 and I love 1. Someday I gotta really sit down with Shining Force 2.
And that's Explore the Gungan Caves? Gungan. Y'all are ruining my mind.
The decades before prequel to Enter the Gungeon, we finally played it. I think Enter the Gungeon could have used this Yoda, frankly. Oh, Jesus.
So here's the best game. Maybe of all time.
Okay.
Many songs there are about Jedi adventures.
Oh, no.
Only a Tatooine band knows Anakin's favorite.
Oh, no. Are we doing this?
Yes, we are.
Create a special songbook for Anakin. Your mission, this is. 4 sets of songs there are.
The boys are
red
all here.
Songs are the mm-hmm. most difficult to learn. Green is a good place to
thank
begin.
Thank you, Jill Katz, for
begin,
the subscription.
Click on the song.
You may want to unsubscribe after you hear these songs.
Welcome and thank you.
So this one is also, this one I would say is directly educational. This just straight up teaches you how to read
I don't think Yoda's going to say what kind of music this is. We all know it.
We all know what
we've
it
all
is.
We've all read Wikipedia.
So let's do one of these and we'll do a harder song. But...
The Jawa will help you. Sing the songs he will.
A, E, E.
Your turn it is. press keys with the same colors and letters you must. Same as the ones the Jawa sang. Yes. If a mistake you make, click on the staff. Erase the notes, it will.
Mm-hmm.
Click A-E-E-D. Here, you can. Hear the song again, you will.
Also change what kind of instrument it is. Let's change it to whatever that is. So, A, B, E.
Oh, nice steel drum.
You're like, oh, music, but...
God rest ye merry gentlemen.
Good, yeah. So there's a secret to this game I'm excited to reveal.
Is there?
This game...
Very well, you have
jam-packed.
Print out your song, you can.
Hold on.
Words for singing,
make sure you
too.
Print out your
follow
song.
This path.
Mm-hmm.
Take this path, Here and sing the song, you can.
Mm-hmm.
Replay the song
Cookie's
on the
dancing.
Keyboard this path allows. Learn a new song, you can. Take this path, yes.
What are those notes on the side? Are those
These
like
are
flats?
These are vocal songs. It is filled with vocal tracks.
Oh.
There's at least probably 20 different songs.
Oh my god.
Gungans live where the creatures swim, will eat you if they capture you.
Oh,
they swim
around
all day and night
song.
With no sound. Gungans
is this a sea shanty?
It is. Will
eat you if they capture you. They swim around without the slightest sound.
Let's do something harder.
Alex.
Here's the thing. Some of these songs are good. So this is the hardest level. And this one is actually kind of hard if you don't know how to sight read.
La 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 la.
So I hope you know how to sight read.
Oh yeah. Oh man. It's been so long since I've had to identify notes on a staff. Yeah, I think you got it.
Yeah, it's been a while, but I remember.
Wow, yeah.
So do you like the Ska revival?
Smoke on the water.
I was gonna say, do you like the Big Band revival? Because this is a song from that era and it sounds just like it.
Performed by Seth MacFarlane himself. The original Jizz Whaler.
Okay, but we want to hear the... No.
That song was cool.
Oh, it didn't... Oh, it did finish it for me. Okay. Here we go. You ready?
Let's go to Tatooine.
I told you!
All but for Tatooine.
Cherry Poppin' Jedi.
The bounty hunters come from every place, then they disappear without a trace. Every single smuggler's got something to sell. Great smugglers, and still worse yet, they will trade you for all hard cold cash that they can get. Every single smuggler's got something to sell.
I love that Jawa up there.
So
really selling it.
Goodness, you're quite the musician. For a human, that is.
Excuse you.
So there's so many of these. We are already running late, so I can't go through them, but I want y'all to know.
I want one more.
Wish to Can make we play your own one music?
More? Okay. Okay, just for you.
La 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 la.
Wow 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 wow
oh my
wow
God.
Wow.
Hold on.
Between ourselves, you might listen carefully. My hearing circuits report
yeah,
you're a bit
It was a
too
B,
high.
Not a C. Hmm.
Fine.
Putting on the... Yep. Yep. That's basically what it is.
Oh my god.
These all sound kind of like putting on the ritz.
They do. Alright, let's hear the full version.
Yes.
Better get ready, better get set. Better get ready, better get set to go. For racers fly, fly right through the sky.
There's something very Philip CDI about this. I think that's why I like it.
Yes!
Very children's musical
the
theater.
Musician. For a human, that is.
So, this is great. I don't know what else to say other than this is the best thing in any Star Wars game. It is wonderful.
That pretty much rules, yeah.
You can make your own songs. You can print them out. Yoda's here. This guy. It's wonderful. Why don't we click on them?
Thanks for the bits, Crush Gals. Yes,
oh, thank you.
Episode 1 is good now.
I
Retroactively,
agree.
It's now good.
Do come back. As
better
soon as your
ready,
circuits permit.
Better get set.
So it's
Gonna
great,
race
right?
a pod race and be sad about your mom. What a game.
I knew you'd like
I don't think we're going to top this. Between Family Guy Yoda and
but
the great songs.
But finish what you begin and return another day.
Oh, just suit riot. No.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
No.
There's been a lot of unrepeatable things posted in chat. Thank you all.
All right, that's Yoda's Challenge Activity Center.
That is damn good for an activity center.
Mm-hmm.
When I hear activity center, I just think of like clip art you can print out, put on a t-shirt or something. But mm-hmm. no, this was fully interactive. Had a dungeon crawler, original vocal songs, dialogue from the original cast members in some cases.
Yeah.
Super high effort.
And the thing is, this is kind of, and now you see the first couple of games, those were more activity centers. But let's go to our next game, because in between the activity centers games, they made another normal game. Like, I think that's a little mean, but
normal game.
This is they made one last not kind of, you know how that, like you said, that game had a CDI feel.
Yeah.
Made one non-CDI feel game, aside from Super Bombad Racing, Lucas Learning did. They did Star Wars Pit Droids. Now, with this one, we're also just playing the demo, because, again, I do not have enough time.
Folks, if you know ahead of time, tell me, what is a pit droid? And how is it different from a regular droid?
Do you want me to tell you?
No, I want the chat to tell me. I want their theories. Whether or not you know what it is or not, I want to know what you think a pit droid is. I think it's like, you know, the pit in NASCAR.
Ah, these are pit droids. You gotta tell them what to do every minute.
Oh, is that really what
so,
it is?
Yes.
I was right.
I got a deal on a whole shipload of these pit droids. Maybe too many, but in the race arena, you never know. There are deals to be made, eh?
Like his best.
But
it's
not
nice
if
best.
They go wandering like the all over the place. Somebody's gotta get all these pit droids headed where they belong. Good luck!
Hey. They could have sprung for the animation on that. That felt a little cheap to me.
Maybe in the full game there is. This is, again, just a demo.
Okay.
So, this is a puzzle game. And it's a good one.
Hey, it's your favorite uncomfortable stereotype.
Yeah, basically. So, Pit Droids is kind of like Lemmings.
Is this Minmo?
Is it?
It looks like Minmo
to
me.
This does have a Minmo vibe, yeah. Okay. So I'm going to choose a puzzle, since this is all we can do. But I like this game, and I want to grab the full version at some point. Also, I just want to say the music in this game is so good.
Okay.
That's actually consistent with these games. There's some real jams in them.
Oh. Incredible Machine. That's what this is, right?
Is that it? I wouldn't know. I haven't.
It's similar.
Yeah. I think we'll just do something.
Or isometric Lemmings, if you prefer.
What do you think of the song, Danny?
This is good.
Okay, let's actually get on.
Nice and chill.
Okay, I think that's where we need to hold on.
Just hanging out in the ungodly warm, arid wastes of Tatooine.
Sounds good.
Staring off at the three suns, going blind.
Okay, he is not close enough, so let's just...
In Choo-Choo Bowl Machine. Yeah, there is a little bit of Choo-Choo Rocket in here, isn't there? Actually, no, it's entirely Choo-Choo Rocket. You're right.
Hold on.
Oh, just barely.
Yeah, I'll fix this. There we go. And there we go. Yeah, it's just basically Choo-Choo. But it's got this really good, like, jazz? Oh, this guy.
You and I both know they don't call it jazz, but
listen,
I'll concede the point.
Please. No, you little...
He's going off on his own. You can't control him. I'd imagine making this isometric makes this much more challenging than something like Choo Choo Rocket.
It does.
Which is directly overhead.
Yeah, there's a grid you can use, which helps.
I didn't know it was hex-based.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's a strategy RPG. Oh, you can drag those around in real time, even.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
So make them face different directions. And then I can move back here to...
Yeah, that's the droid we affectionately refer to as Little Bastard.
That's the Little Bastard.
Got him home.
And that's Pit Droids. I'm going to do another game.
Yeah, do another.
I really like these. So you also have to drag them over certain things to unlock other things. So, yeah, let's...
guess this is slightly after Choo Choo Rocket. This is 99, right?
So yes.
The Dreamcast was a thing, and if Choo Choo Rocket wasn't out, they would have certainly learned about it being in development or something. Why not put droids in it? Why not have them walk over keys on the ground?
Why not? Why not do it to this smooth jazz or whatever?
The music really does make this game.
It does. Okay, this should do it, hopefully. Let's go.
I'm sure if he tried, Alex could have worked out a more complicated solution, but that's just how it works. No! No! There they go! Heading off into the desert.
That's my bad.
This was on iOS? This would be a great mobile game. But then Big D Disney decided it was not to be, I guess.
They're kind of dumb, because this is great. This is... So, did one of them die?
I like the understated marimba.
Me too.
Ah, look at him go. It's like a well-oiled machine. Mm-hmm. No grabbing and tugging here.
Yeah. These people long. And unfortunately, since one of them died, I didn't get it, and I'd have to restart the thing. But there's also an R2-D2 option. You can just... He beeps.
Was there a Mario sound in there? I wouldn't doubt it.
And that's Pit Droids.
Nice.
What do you think, Danny?
I kind of like that. That's a unique concept. It uses the license well. It's got this interface.
Ooh, and of course, you know, we got this. You got voice. Yeah, good
stuff.
It has
Comic Sans. I have no complaints.
I like Pit Droids a lot, and it is their last normal game. Everything else is extremely multimedia. I do not know how else to describe it. Just, okay. I also like that this guy is praying. I'm sorry.
He is praying.
He, look at this.
Please, droid god, please save me from this hell.
It's training. How do I get out of
here? Amen.
There we go. Okay.
Okay, so Alex made us watch this to... Let us enjoy some nice, normal games before really going off the deep end.
Oh, yeah.
That box art is really cool.
Oh, okay. In the full game, those guys are animated, and that robot is rolling dice. I love that. Okay, good to know. They're not praying. They're gambling. Much better. So, good stuff. I like Pit Droids, and I think that if you have a chance to play it, play it. Good stuff.
But let's move on to the stuff we really want to see.
Oh, boy.
I don't want normal games. I want abnormal games. I want a game that came out on March 20th, the year 2000, a game by the name of Anakin's Speedway.
Anakin's Speedway is geared towards babies? I don't know who else to put it. And...
Oh, right, not dice, chance cubes.
Sorry, you're right.
Gotta get in the universe.
So this is absolutely a multimedia game. This is extremely multimedia.
I can't wait. Give me all the unfiltered multimedia. Boy, they made a lot of these over the space of like 3 years.
Hey, do you like Ben Quadranero?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Anakin, and I'm a pod racer pilot. I'm glad you're here to help us build some really cool tracks. By the way, have you seen anyone flying around out of control?
No.
I'm out of control here! I'm up!
Uh-oh, he's headed for the pod racer's hut. I'll meet you there.
Somehow this is not on CDI, despite looking exactly like a... Oh my god. He changed art style again.
I don't care what universe you're from, that's got to hurt.
Holy Wumba!
We'll come back to meet the other pod racer pilots later. 3PO will clean things up.
So,
it has the two-headed announcer.
Mm-hmm.
I love that character.
Ooh, there are this some squishy, fishy things I should tell you.
Good.
When you click on the stop button, then I don't go. Oh no! Stops me like a dead banana. These numbers make us go. 3 is super fast. 2 is medium, and 1 is slow. To start all over, or some say reset, click right here, and reset you will get. When we get
some
too low on
reset.
Fuel, click here, and the droids will use their refueling tools. This changes the planet your track is on. Lots of choices that are squiggly-icious fun. Oh, that button takes you to the hut, so you can change pod racer pilots. Don't do it. Rejection! The track changes with...
But this guy's got problems. Moving, you'll need to hit the stop button first and make it quit. Oh, now you know what I know. Time to build some track.
So this is just a play around game. You click on pieces of the track and it changes it. And
Clegg Holdfast, you say.
So we don't have to play as Ben. I know some of you are Ben stands and others are anti-Ben. So we can choose other people to play as.
You can be the other pod racers?
Yes. From the outer rim. Welcome to Luke. Anakin. Click on a driver
to go to the little track. Luke.
Ben, I don't know who this is. Speed and I will be happy to let you know what's happening. Hold on, I clicked on something random and something happened.
Is this an Easter egg?
Welcome to the jukebox joint, where the fun never stops.
Is there music?
Oh yeah.
Reed, I'd give that dancing droid a 10. How about you?
Hold on.
Folks, oh my god. Not only is there air guitar in the Star Wars universe, but that droid was doing a Jimi Hendrix bit. That raises so many questions.
Hey!
This raises even more questions.
And like a multimedia game, there's random stuff. Oh god, it's Jar Jar. Random stuff you can click on. Now, there's not a lot of Jar Jar in this, but they're still present.
You found the secret Jar Jar.
Now we know about Gascano. I know people are asking about Gascano. They like winning races. They don't like Sebulba. They like waving. And they love Zen Boogie milkshakes.
Favorite food? Zen Boogie milkshakes. Pod racer, Ord Pedrovia.
Ord Pedrovia.
Dislikes, Sebulba. Likes, winning pod races.
There's a knock-knock joke.
Favorite joke? Knock-knock.
Dudoka.
Yoda.
Yoda.
Hoo. Yodale hee hoo.
They stole a joke from the chat early on in the stream. I can't believe it. I'm livid. They stole
okay?
a joke from 20 years in the future.
Let's see what they have to say about Sebulba, who I love.
Name Sebulba.
Oh, this guy.
I love Sebulba.
Dislikes everybody.
Dislikes everybody. Hobbies. Cheating. Favorite food, Barunda swamp suckers. Favorite joke, knock knock.
Dudoka.
Jabba.
Jabba ooh.
Jabba the Hutt's a great big mutt.
Is that a joke?
That doesn't really fit the format, but.
Okay, I want to hear Anakin's favorite joke. I'm sorry.
Name, Anakin Skywalker.
Look at this piece of shit.
Anakin Dr. Orba.
You're so
this
mean.
Is probably Greg Proops, yes.
Dislikes Sebulba.
Oh,
likes
I love Bantha Burgers.
Pod racing and pod made.
Hey, that sounds really good.
Favorite joke?
What's the favorite joke?
Knock.
Dudoka.
Anakin.
Anakin, ooh.
Anakin, you can do. I can do better.
He does look like Bruno the Kid. This is pissing me off.
Yeah, that pisses me off, too.
No, and last but not least, my favorite, Ben.
Name, Ben Quadaneros.
Isn't this the guy who died at the starting line or something?
Yes.
Dislikes getting boo-boos.
The way that they said that.
Favorite joke? Knock, knock.
Dudoka.
Toodle.
Toodaloo.
Toodaloo to you too.
All right. And so I think I'm going to.
What's a nerve knocker?
I'm afraid. That sounds like a really wild drug.
Yeah.
Wait.
Hey! It's like we're in Vegas.
I was gonna say, this is so mold. This is so CDI.
This is definitely the silliest game we've played so far. You can click on the... Oh yeah, those are the gay rats. We found them.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it looks like we got it.
I think it's time to do a race
from the
now.
Outer rim. Welcome to the hut, where the pod racers hang out. Click on a driver to go to the track.
Yeah, I guess Hendrix, he's just all over the universe. In all time periods, all fantasy worlds.
So, should I play as Ben or Anakin?
Ben.
Thank you. Ben is awful. Ben is genuinely not a good racer, so you actually have to slow him down around curves.
All goes to you! I'm Ben Quadaneros, but Ben will do. Build your best course and I'll give it a go. But click on me first or we'll never know.
Yeah, Danny did mean Jizzy Head Droid.
I was specifically not reading that, but thank you.
Sorry.
Well, at least this fleshes out the other pod racers who, frankly, we didn't see nearly enough of in episode one. Some of them died right at the starting line. Some made it a lap before they got taken down by the freaking sand people. Tusken Raiders.
Tusken Raiders.
That's who I'm looking for. Yeah.
This seems good. What do you think about? Hold on.
Right, eat this.
Oh yeah, half pipe. Is Tony Hawk one of the racers?
There we go. Looks good. This looks very impossible for our friend Ben. Let's hope he doesn't die. Let's go.
Oh, Ben's pod racer exploded, but he survived. Okay. Oh, it's happening. The race. Pull him over. Yeah. Past the half pipe, over the bumps, around the crisscross, the loop-de-loops, and that's lap one. Dead. He died. He's dead.
Wow and wiggly woos. Going that fast causes boo-boos.
So, you can also go to different planets and do races there. Let's do a race on a different planet, and then I think...
Alex, what the fuck is this game?
Swamp Barunda, a slush...
Yeah, swamp planet.
This seems really muddled and confused, which just adds to its CDI-ness.
Welcome to Barunda, home of the
biggest... Oh, you get to experience
stimpy,
pod races
stinky,
in other
muddy,
worlds.
...funny, duddy swamp you'll ever see. Always wear safety gear. You hear?
This is awful. I would hate this. Let's go.
Yeah. Can we make this happen?
I'm going to go slow this time.
Except, well, I'm going to click on this. I know I'm going to regret this, but...
Oh, they're doing okay. They're not crashing.
Ooh, scary. This is scary.
And the first lap finished.
I don't know if I go fast. And Ben died.
Whoa, oh no, it's a video. I can't look at this now.
No, we got too much.
But thank you. I will look at this.
Guybrush is voicing Ben here. Amazing.
What the hell?
So that's
I previewed the video without sound, and I already regret it.
Good. So this is.
When I'm safe, I'm very happy. Bing bing.
You seem very happy, friend. This is
to make the pod racer go. Click a speed button, don't you
know? Okay, Ben, please, I have things to do. This is Anakin Speedway, a game for literal children.
This is the button to.
Hey, that's coming out of the.
I know.
Okay.
Let's do it for a second. Go on.
And that's Anakin Speedway, a game for literal children.
That seemed really simplistic and also complex in the weirdest possible ways, like all the character bios, the unique knock-knock jokes, the just the profound cursedness of it all. It is the most Philip CDI game of all the games we play today.
Well, if you like cursed weird games, you're going to absolutely, if you thought that was like a fun game for babies with weird shit, you're going to love our next game, released August 15th, 2000. It is Star Wars Early Learning Activity Center. And
I love early learning.
I do too. And
you know what I hate? That late learning. All that calculus and shit.
Actually, I'm with you. That stuff fucking sucks. Alright. Just need to hold up. Put the game CD-ROM in.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
Ooh, a different one. They're evolving.
Welcome. You are just in time for our celebration. I'm Queen Amidala.
Alex's fingerprints are all over this game.
Started. Before you play any games, you need to log in by letting us know your name. If you've been here before and you see your name on the guest list, click on it to select it. If you are a new player, you can type in your name by using your keyboard. Click on the picture of the trash can if you want to throw away the name in the box.
It does look a lot more like a Zula.
Click on this button to leave the game. Use the arrows to see more names on the guest list.
That the guest list
when you see your name in the box above the guest list, click here to play.
Invited by the queen herself.
So, we're putting in someone.
I'm pretty sure Padme has had a different voice in every single one of these games we played. They all have a different take on her flat, unemotional voice.
There we go. And I should already have the subtitle option on. Yeah, there we go. No, we don't need printing. There's no printing.
No, keep the printing. Oh.
Okay. Only for you, honey.
We gotta print out my certificate.
Welcome. You are just in time for our celebration. I'm Queen Amidala.
I know. And I'll have... So...
Oh, right. It's all different body doubles. It's in canon.
This takes place literally right after the final scene of The Phantom Menace. So it's celebration time.
I remember this. What happened afterward?
Welcome to the city of
Qui. Shit you've ever seen.
This is where I live.
Anakin!
During the celebration, you can explore Qui the underwater city of Otto Gunga. Each city has three celebration activities.
So you can make music, you can
What's with Funko Pop Anakin? What did they do to him?
The Coliseum.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do the worst game first.
Alright.
I'll let you know what you need to do.
Okay.
All these droids are single color. You need to click on the one that matches the other colors.
Blue is bombast! Excellent!
Somehow you've avoided mentioning the fact that there are four Jar Jars.
They're not Jar Jars, they're Gungan. Jar Jar is the only one from Jar Jar Genesis Aqua.
This droid is up next. He
definitely
needs some
bank. About to say Jar Jar Genitalia.
Absolutely not.
Perfect! Only one more droid to paint!
Okay, hopefully that's better.
Okay. Yeah, this was kind of loud.
Oh, excellent!
Yeah, a little bit more.
Okay, hopefully this is better.
This game wants you to know that it's here.
Yes. I turned it down a lot more. Let me know if it's better now.
Nope, thanks for coming out to enjoy the show.
And that's it. It is literally you just...
That
it is,
was exciting.
Wait, what happened?
At the Naboo Puppet
that's
Theater,
it.
You can help Anakin and Jar Jar create puppet shows.
Yeah, but... Oh, okay.
Don't worry about it. That's supposed to be a weird celebration. You're celebrating by
at
flinging...
The Coliseum,
it's a different fantasy culture. We just have to sit back and accept that this is what they do.
You can help Anakin and Jar Jar create puppet shows.
Oh, I don't want that.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. You have no idea how much you want this.
Puppet show. You get to make up stories, and then Jar Jar will perform them. Making up new stories is easy.
Sounds like hell, right?
You can click here to pick a different story to work on. Each story is about someone different. The story that you're working on, it'll show up here. Click on any of these to make changes to your story. When you're ready to see your story performed, click on me. I'll read the story and Jar Jar will work the puppets.
Yep,
hello,
welcome to the Gay Space Radio.
I'm going to be a star.
Oh, man.
Jar Jar Superstar, baby.
Theater, click on this round button. This is your print button. Click on it to print out puppets or a copy of her play. Okay.
That is Jake Lloyd as Anakin. Wow.
Oh, they got Jake Lloyd for this. That's pretty incredible, actually.
So we could do...
That Watto. That Anakin.
You know what? I don't want Watto. I want the forgotten hero, Qui-Gon.
Yeah.
Qui-Gon, sorry.
Anakin found Qui-Gon.
Was Anakin sad? Was he happy? Was he shy?
I think he was shy. Or tired.
I think he was tired. Did they
Anakin was tired.
So, did they dance, laugh, jump, or race? I think they danced. And
didn't they
I
dance
think...
quickly?
No, they didn't dance quickly. They danced loudly.
Loudly.
All right, are we ready for the play?
Loudly.
How do you dance? Okay, I guess we're going to find out.
All right, Anakin.
Anakin's story.
Huh.
One day, not too long ago... Anakin was tired.
I'm going home. Oh my god.
Anakin found Qui-Gon.
Whoop.
I love this game. I'm sorry.
Here you are.
This is unbelievable.
This is...
No. No. Stop it. No.
And they danced loudly.
Oh no.
Yay! The end. You're very creative. I don't think anyone else would have been able to make up that story.
That was my initial reaction when I played this.
Well done. Well done, Jar Jar. You know, You're not good at anything, but you're good at puppet shows. I think we found his area of expertise.
You picked a story about Darth Maul. Yeah. I hope it's not scary.
Darth Maul had a pet.
A pet. Darth Maul had a pet.
Sounds disgusted.
Darth Maul pranced on Tatooine.
Darth Maul pranced on Tatooine.
Then he,
he stumbled.
Then he
and he landed.
We should get started.
In a bathtub.
On one of these,
or pajamas.
In a pajamas.
Then he stumbled and landed in his pajamas.
Are y'all ready for this?
Take it away, Jar Jar.
This is gonna, be one of those new things they're putting on
Disney Plus.
Yes.
One day, not too long ago, Darth Maul had a pet.
Darth Maul had a pet.
Aww, how cute.
It's a baby Bantha. Yep, he is.
He's prancing.
He's doing that.
Then he stumbled and landed in his pajamas.
Mm-hmm.
Oh! Yay!
The end.
Jar Jar is really helping to sell this.
Story. Yeah, like,
this wouldn't work at all if not for his vocalizations.
Good. Do you want one more? Are you good?
One more.
Okay, can we do Jar Jar?
Yeah.
Okay.
The star of the show. Let's do it.
Jar Jar. I can't wait to see what kind of trouble he gets into.
Then Jar Jar was content.
I can't.
Thank you, Tepid Snake, for the 36 months, 3 whole years, and Darth Maul as a 1-pound Bantha. Thank you.
Oh my god, this is so... I already like the story. He was bored.
Bored.
Actually, he should be unhappy. I'm sorry, Jar Jar.
Yeah, Jar Jar deserves to be unhappy.
I feel bad. Shout out to Ahmed Best, who's had to suffer a lot because of Jar Jar being written like shit. So Jar Jar carried, should he carry a pie or a burden? Carried a, we're going to find out what a gorg is.
Let's see him carry the burden of the cross. I'm sorry, I can't help but read that as content. I'm just so poisoned as a content creator nowadays.
Then he was, should he be giddy, excited, stuff?
We should get started. Just click on
giddy. Giddy.
Then Jar Jar was giddy.
Yeah, let's go.
Jar Jar's story.
This is gonna be messed up.
One day, not too long ago, Jar Jar was unhappy. So, Jar Jar carried a gorg.
Here you are! Moi, moi! La di da di da di da do do di do di do. Oh! Wee!
I feel like I'm losing my mind.
Jar Jar was giddy.
Yay!
Wrong puppet! Uh-oh, Jar Jar, I think you're using the wrong puppet.
Oopsie day.
Then Jar Jar was giddy.
Yay!
Jar Jar, you unbelievable fuck up. Now that's content.
The end. I think I heard Jar Jar laughing.
So,
are you ready to make up another story? Good.
We should move on because...
Bye, thanks for helping out.
As amazing as this is...
I hope you enjoyed the puppet show.
What are you really ready to go insane?
In the Theed Music Hall...
That wasn't the most insane
songs
part.
...with our music droids.
No, before we do that, I'm going to take you to the boring stuff in the underwater.
Okay.
This stuff is so dull in comparison.
At least we get to see the Gungans land.
Misa Boss Nass.
Yeah.
The ruler of Oat at the Gungan Disco Dance Bubble. You so can help Jar Jar learn how to dance.
Okay.
You saying
dance.
This is boring?
Compared to the final thing I'm going to show you, which made me lose my mind, yes.
Okay. Fair enough.
At the Dunk Boss Nass Bubble, you so can send Misa for a swim.
And I think the last one is...
In the Underwater Treasure Hunt. Yusa and Obi-Wan Kenobi will search for hidden clams.
Okay.
Ooh, clams.
It's time to hunt for Gungan treasures.
Here you will find 5 underwater caves. You should explore them all while you and Obi-Wan search for the treasure-filled clams.
So this is just a maze game.
They did do a lot of swimming in the movie, more than you probably remember.
Well, that's because they're, you know, the Gungans are underwater.
That does make sense.
Gungans.
That's a lot of movie, though. There's so much you probably forget about it.
So you use the arrow keys to fly around.
I think the clam is hiding inside the purple frog.
Touch it. And you get a clam. This is for the smallest of children.
We've solved the mystery.
But not you.
And you go around getting all the clams and nothing happens, so. That's one game. Let's get out of here and go back to the others.
You have keen eyes and ears, like a Jedi.
You set in a grand job in the underwater.
I barely did it.
You did a grand job.
I guess. So we're doing this one. This one is also just kind of...
Are you so ready?
This one is not very unhinged. Mass? You're just separating colors, because again, this is a game for children.
I love his 1920 swimsuit.
Isn't it wonderful? That's why I was hoping this would have been better, but no, it's partially dull. I say about a game for like baby babies.
To see me, so go for a swim.
Hey, those are chocobos. What the hell?
Mm-hmm. What you do is you grab the creature.
Right.
And then you put it in the right color.
Uh-oh.
Yusa and Misa are
so it's Chicken Farm.
Yes, this is Chicken Farm with Boss Nass.
Boss Nass will defeat Moose and Squirrel.
Okay, so it's the voice of Boss Nass here. Wow! And...
Uh-oh. Oh.
For an Activity Center game, there's not a lot of creativity you can engage in with it, unlike the other ones, so let's move out of here.
That swimsuit does leave little to the imagination.
Okay, here's the best one.
He has so many outfits.
Welcome to the Gungan Disco Bubble, where all good Gungans come to groove!
I'm here for this.
Hello, Deli Pally. Misa Happy Yusa here to help. Making a dance for Jar Jar Binks is no problem. Let me show you how. Yusa choose where Misa dance by clicking on the round spots. For each spot Yusa pick, Misa also need to pick a dance move. I know 6 Gungan dance steps.
Only 6.
This button changing the music. Click in the picture of the eraser to take away Yusa last move. Click on this button to throw away the dance Yusa been making and start it.
Throw this
one.
Dance away. No this more dance.
Yes, JJR or DD Jar.
Click on it and Misa will dance. Click here when Yusa want to leave and try another game.
Got it.
Why would I want to do that though?
Which dance move should Yusa do first?
Well, first let's see what music we got. We got this.
SpongeBob music,
There we go, some actual like... What do you think about this French-ass music?
I don't like the Gungan waltz. Not a fan.
Let's go with this, you like this?
Yeah, alright.
Okay.
Here so... in Bikini Bottom, Jar Jar meets his new best friend in this crossover fanfiction.
Click on any of these colored down spots to tell Jar Jar where to go next.
Step to the side.
What dance move now should Misa do here?
I don't like that.
Why does the tongue have to figure into this?
It's good. Let's add another dance move.
You know what this is? This is Spice Girls for PS1.
I was gonna say, we played a game just like this.
Somehow we've not played the Spice Girls game on PS... I'm sorry, Spice World is what it's called.
This is... This reminds me of that one game from not Cat... The Flash game for Fruity Pebbles.
Oh yeah!
More, and then I think we're ready to see our dance.
Oh,
beautiful jar dance. I really like that disgusting movie.
He's pretty restrained from what I'm expecting from Jar Jar at this point.
So I got that dance move, that dance move.
Except for the tongue thing, that's what I would expect.
There we go. I like this one. He's just waving his hands in the air.
Ditto Fantasy, I think you have a point. It does teach kids how to deal with messed up early 2000s UIs, though, which were very popular for a number of years. Step to the side. Now do the kick dance. Yeah. Step to the side, get ready to do the tongue thing nobody likes. Oh, yeah, there it is.
This does not have a nude code, thank God, but...
It's probably a mod out there.
No, I... The music is loud, and so's the
crowd! Oh, he's so expressive.
He is, right?
And somehow less off-putting than his 3D model in the movies. He actually looks cartoonish and... Well, not exactly pleasant to look at, but still. Hey, Jordan, welcome!
Hey!
You came at a great time.
Oh, you're about to lose your mind with the next game. So, that's this game. That's the Jar Jar dance. Oh, let's just leave him there. You okay with that?
Yeah, just let him tongue dance for the rest of time.
Okay, so let's go back to the surface and do the final game, which is,
I'm very pleased to see you again. In the Theed Music Hall, you can make up songs with our music droids.
So this doesn't have any lyrics. This is another music making game, but this has a real unhinged energy that I appreciate.
Okay. Songs with the music droids. I'll show you how.
Okay.
Oh no, you had to bring up Brain Dead 13.
These buttons.
I can see. Yeah, that it has that kind of vibe.
Mm-hmm. Click on this button to choose a music droid that plays a different instrument. There are four different music droids in all.
Mm-hmm.
This button will change the song that you play along with.
And this.
This is your melody map. Each melody area plays a different note. You can use this button to pick different
the laser
melody
grid.
Maps. Mm-hmm. You should try them all. There's a game you can play using the melody map. Click here to turn the game on.
Kind of sucks. Sure that, so first of all, he looks like he's a freaking Robotnik droid.
Wow.
And the music thing is just...
That's combination Robotnik droid and, oh, that one robot from Chrono Trigger. You know who I'm talking about.
So you're like, okay, you got some other matrixes, too. You can do this one.
Okay, vertical, horizontal.
Well, let's try out some
square-based.
Okay.
Yeah, it's robot bumps.
Not bad. What else we got? Oh!
That was fantastic!
Stick with this one.
I can't wait to hear the next one.
But we need a new matrix. This doesn't seem unhinged enough.
Yeah. This is not a digital.
Let's try another one.
This is not a digital audio workspace, Alex. This is not compatible with our new mixer.
This is Jubeat, yes. But I like.
I wish they had Star Wars music in Jubeat.
This.
Shark beat.
And then this one. But there's other instruments we can play too.
That's a saxophone droid. It makes great music.
Hey, do you like clown jazz?
That's the biggest saxophone I ever did see. Wow. It's like a combination French horn, baritone, alto, all the brass instruments. And woodwinds.
Jar Jar over here in the front row. Thank you, Jar Jar. We appreciate the support. Violin.
It's a violin droid. That's great.
Is it great? You know, someone should have programmed these droids to have musical theory instead of just playing random notes.
And here we go, the best music you'll hear on stream.
I guess procedurally generated content is the new thing nowadays, so maybe this has an audience now.
And then last but not least, the game you can play, which is... It is incredible. Anyway, so...
Auga!
Danny, what do you think of the soundscape?
I'm in hell. It's a combination Star Wars music, clown music, Augas.
This is what Luke can remember. Lucas had input on these games. George Lucas had input on these games. I'm sure.
He saw this and he was just like, yeah, that's good. Very musical. It's what I hear in my head every night when I go to sleep.
Can you put in the Christmas Tom song? So this is, I don't know what else to say other than this is my favorite game probably ever made, just doing this. Just Just making you all lose your mind. I need to go before I...
Was that a duck?
Yes.
Come back soon.
The people of
what was that one scene on I Think You Should Leave with the weird guy playing the piano making all the sound effects?
And Jar Jar.
That's what that was.
Oh my god. So, let's go. This was... Yes, I am very sure.
Are you sure? Are you sure you want to quit
that
this?
That was Star Wars Early Learning Activity Center. We are running in... There's only two more games left on the stream. We're going to go a little over here. I hope that's okay.
That's fine. But let's blaze through our last couple games. Oh, I don't know how you can top that last one. Oh, my God.
Yeah, I don't know either.
Between freaking... the weird-ass Anakin they had in there. The randomly generated music. The Jar Jar dance.
So, we have a new game. Next one is Star Wars Math, Jabba's Game Galaxy. Came out in September 1st, 2000. This one has, do you know how you were like, oh, the Jar Jar looks great. I love the way he's animated. And like, oh no, Anakin looks like a Funko Pop, haha, or whatever.
Yeah.
What if they didn't have that charming art style when you saw them?
Uh-oh.
What if they were 3D animated? Also, what if Argonaut made one of these games? Well, you're about to find out, because that's who did Jabba's Game Galaxy, and that's what's next.
Incredible. Argonaut, makers of iNinja and also Star Fox, you know, that kind of thing. I guess they got caught up in the whole Lucas Learning thing. Grift.
I wouldn't call it a grift. I mean...
What 8-year-old would say that Jabba is their favorite character?
Hold on.
Delete.
These games are also two-player, but I have no idea how to set that up. Do you even want to try?
No.
Okay.
Oh yeah, Croc. How could I forget Croc?
Hold on.
The people who brought you Croc bring you... Gay Rat the...
Yeah, this game is a little bit more intense. Gay Rat Hut.
Our simulated Pentium 133 is choking on this game.
Mm-hmm. So this has a story to it.
Gabe the Rat is good.
Oh, that's much better.
Look at this animation.
Hey, you can tell Argonaut did it.
This was originally a Star Fox game. Oh no, we're gonna crash on Dinosaur Planet.
So how do you like this?
You again.
Too bad for you, huh? New ships don't come cheap.
And do you like this art style? Really
not especially.
Me, I suggest you pay a visit to Jabba's Game Plaza.
Yes, Smooth Watto is here.
Very, very lucky.
That's what it is. It's his smoothness.
Zappo! Where is that droid? You just can't find good health these days. Here's a data pad. If you have any questions about anything,
I have lots of questions.
With my droid, Zeppo.
Hi, welcome to Tatooine. CP70 at your service. But please call me Zeppo. All my friends do.
Nobody post Smooth Watto.
Do not.
Give you a map of the city.
Oh yeah. A map of the city might come in handy, huh?
Watto is an elf, yes.
He is one of the... Well, technically, they're all elves, if you think about it. They're all alien life forms to us. Ironically, Anakin is an elf to Watto, if you think about it.
Whoa.
So, basically, you crash-landed on this planet.
Wow, that sucks.
Yeah, it does. Tatooine, I think. And you need to go play... you need to gamble and do these gambling games to win money. To be able to fix your ship. So let's do a couple games, see how far we can get. And then
so we're essentially role-playing Anakin, who finds himself in a similar situation. Mm. Gotta buy yourself off this damn planet.
Mm-hmm. So there's four games, and this is the most directly educational game. This is straight up an educational math game.
Well, I refuse to learn.
Okay, this is... You'd think Rat's Race would be the best one, but it is the absolute worst. We are not doing the demo. I will go through, like, one round of this and move on. I hate Rat's Race. I'm sorry. It's basically Trivial Pursuit, but without the trivia.
So, Candyland.
Yeah.
What character is this, Alex?
I'm turning up the audio a little bit so you can hear Rat's.
Is this a different Watto?
I don't know who Rats is. I don't know if he's exclusive to this game, but Rats is... I don't know.
Is this
I am
Grotto?
Conflicted.
Would you like me to show you how to play this here Rats race?
No, please.
Oh, Rats race?
Rat dies in the movie? Is he in the movie? Okay.
Oh, is this a character?
A real go-getter.
It does sound like Toad.
He left behind his wife and children?
Hit this button to start the spinner. The Chubas do the rest.
Okay. So you have to roll an odd number to be able to move. And then each thing you land on, you have to do a simple math puzzle. And you have to collect all the colors of the pieces. So it's Trivial Pursuit, but you get a piece by doing math. Hey, an actual odd number. When I first played, I got 6 evens in a row, and I was so mad because you can't do anything if you get an even. Yes, please move forward. All right.
Oh, I see. Okay, this is where the math comes in.
Are they equal to each other, or is one greater than or less than the other? Get it right, and you win big credit.
All right. It is. There you go.
Yeah. You see, you want the mouse going towards the bigger one, because mm-hmm. Pac-Man is the bigger number.
Oh, that's good. My teacher told me it was an alligator eating the bigger number.
Oh, that works, too. You can
with
draw teeth on
too.
It.
It's really cool.
Oh, that's way better than mine.
Literally the only way I can remember it. And then they go, and yeah, you have to go around doing math puzzles and, math, like, simple basic math. And, once you collect all the pieces, you can move over to this part.
Teen Girl Squad.
Yes, that is it. We're moving on from Rats game, though, because this really does go on for a while.
Wow, there's a whole lot of Homestar Runner in these games. Who knew?
So Jabba's here, so is Sebulba. Let's do,
Digpato. Is that a P? No, that's an O.
It's an O. So this game is weird.
Excuse me? Greetings.
It's like...
My name is Timto.
Bingo poker, you get four digits, and you have to rearrange. It's like it feels like a Price is Right game.
That little critter over there.
I love them. They're a number droid.
Their purpose is just to show a number?
No, I will tell chat how to.
Oh, you're already an expert.
Yes, I am. I actually kind of like this game as a concept. It's interesting.
Pull the lever.
So... First thing you have to do is choose how you're going to play the game.
Oh, he's flexing. Did you see that?
Where's my... There we go.
He was holding up an arm.
We've got a lot of different play modes, but this time we have to make
the highest number.
Highest number possible.
Delightful digits.
What did we say last game about completely incomprehensible UIs? Because I'm reminded of that again.
So you can either place a number in the first, second, or third spot, or get rid of the number.
Oh my god, you're right. This is a Price is Right
game. I told
game.
You. That was the 5 at the end.
Your play gets me worked up.
Put all the numbers in the right place and you win a new car!
And you gotta wait for this guy. That's actually the worst part of this game. This guy takes a long time to take his turn, which is why we're only gonna do, like, one round of, like...
Excuse me, a new pod racer!
This guy pod racer? Sorry, I don't know who this cool alien is.
Star Wars experts, who is this character? What film did he appear in? Was it a comic? Was it something that's been obviated from canon now? He is a pod racer. It's Timto.
Timto, sorry. Timto also really likes doing Price is Right style gambling games, which I appreciate.
Hell, who doesn't?
Same.
Does he do Cliffhanger? I like that game.
Let's get another one. I just like the idea of Price is Right being a game on
Everyone
world.
Loves Price is Right, though.
Yeah.
The elderly, little kids, sick at home from school.
Mm-hmm.
Bob Barker.
So I used all my digits, so I'm going to have to throw away the last one because...
You got
You
got a Pizza Hut ad.
I should have put that up front. I would have... Okay, this guy's going to probably put this up front.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to win this one.
No.
Oh, Plinko's good, too.
Plinko's
I'm a Plinko fan for sure.
I won! Holy crap!
You did?
Yeah, I got the highest number. See? 745, and they had 574. So...
I get it.
I got 20 credits for that.
Nice!
It's a lot of work for 20 credits.
You'll buy your way to freedom any day now.
Next is Sebulba's game, and I have one problem with this game, and that is, and I am sorry, I know it's Monday, but Sebulba talks kind of sexy. I'm sorry.
Welcome, my friend.
See?
This is the game of dueling dice, and I am Sebulba. Are you ready to take on the greatest player of all time? Or do you want me to show you how to play the game first?
That's very sensual.
Okay, thank That's you.
Incredibly sensual.
I'm only sort of insane here.
Stupid,
okay.
Stupid, sexy Sebulba. No, everyone agrees. It's very concerning for sure.
I'll go first.
So this is like Yahtzee meets blackjack.
Hey, these are regular dice, not chance cubes. I saw the movie. You can't fool me.
The goal is to get as close to 30 without getting over 30. So. Mm.
That's the goal in real life, too.
well, I lost badly, dude.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, so this is 6, 7, 8. Just type in 8. Oh, God, I have to hold on.
No, you gotta use the interface. It makes a funny noise every time. Citricola, yes. It's so violent when the dude falls off the mountain. It's just so unexpected.
The way he says that is correct is very, I don't know.
Can we just watch The Price is Right next Monday?
I mean, if you can avoid copyright hell for it, sure. So yeah, what you have to do is you have to add, you add numbers after every round, and that's like, if you get them wrong, I don't know what happens wrong, but I think you may lose? I don't know.
Hmm.
Okay, so. I did play one round where he didn't get a question right, and it was really weird because I'm like, you're an adult, and this is... another 8, so...
Oh, this is looking pretty good. I think you may end up winning this.
Okay, so... Then you gotta type in the number of the equation, that's 16.
What if you hit 30 exactly? Is that like blackjack?
Yes, it's good. And I'm gonna be like, yeah, I'll keep going. And when you want to stop going, you just click on the hand button that stops you.
Arnold, yeah, I'm real curious about what Price is Right looked like on NES. What would that have even been?
I don't like the way he... his finger... no. So aside from the absolute agony slowness in which these pit droids move, this is my favorite gaming game.
It's the most cerebral game of the bunch.
Mm-hmm.
Makes you think. Roll them once again. Let's hit that 30. Oh, 10. That's good.
Yeah, I think after...
You should stand on 10.
I will. I mean, that was my plan.
26.
No, not minus.
This is good because it teaches kids about blackjack.
Yeah, it teaches kids how to gamble. And I will stand.
Mm-hmm. I think we got this, folks.
Stop button on the scoreboard to freeze your score and stop your turn.
Do you want to freeze your score?
All right, let's see if Sebulba wins. Oh, he's going to get...
Wow. The house wins every time.
Wow. Best of Jabba's Game Galaxy, not Best of Stream. Best of Stream, I think, was...
any of the musical numbers.
Yes, the musical numbers. Me. And he hit 30, and he cheated, and I hate him. Stupid, sexy Sebulba.
What's he gonna say?
No, he's still going.
Wait, what?
Oh, no, he stopped.
Okay. Yep, dump them all in the garbage.
Mm-hmm. His favorite thing is cheating. You're right. That's what the pod racing game said.
Each and every one of them screams.
See what I mean about this game? This in particular game's pacing being very slow and...
Here come the last 10.
Hold on. That was the thing with the other games. They could be kind of like the other games for babies we played. They could be kind of slow, but they weren't this badly paced.
Incredible.
Last but not least is Holochex. I do not think I'm going through an entire game of Holochex.
Oh, Holochex are delicious.
I was gonna say, it sounds good, huh?
I like the chocolate Holochex.
Are you ready to see Jabba?
Jabba the Hutt? There he is.
And it's him speaking Galactic Basic instead of Hutt, so that's cool.
You look as green as a monkey lizard.
Hey.
Would you like me to show you how to play holochecks?
No, it's just like checkers, but with diagonals.
Oh.
It's a grid checkers.
Oh, Chinese checkers. Is that what it is?
I can choose my characters. I want to be those guys. And you can choose different boards too, but it's... You've seen it once, you've seen it before. This guy goes very, very slow, and... We're already almost out of time.
Oh, he takes his time.
Mm-hmm.
Really gotta think about that. Do you have to take jumps if they're available?
Yes.
Oh. Get out of here. I will never Google smooth Jabba the Hutt. Not in my life. Yeah, kids should have to learn Hutt ease.
Agree.
Bo-ho-ho-ho. That's most of the language.
Look closer at your monsters.
I'm looking. That's an illegal move.
So you... I'm supposed to be able to jump him, but I don't know...
Jump my monster. According to the rules, if your monster can capture the opponent's monster...
I see. Okay, I see.
And believe me, I'm all about the rules.
Oh, Jabba loves rules.
Interesting, 81 Rambler. That does provide a little bit more insight into Jabba's personality.
I actually love that. That actually is totally Jabba. Apparently, I learned that in the Hutt Legends, like the Star Wars Legends canon, like the unofficial canon or whatever, or maybe it's official now, but one of Jabba's family members tried to take down Jabba the Hutt because, shit you not, they wanted to go the business to be nicer, and they thought that Jabba was too horny with all the Twi'lek ladies around him. They were like,
we gotta clean up this act.
That's literally it's
this
like,
whole business, it's not child friendly. You gotta do math games, Jabba, math games.
I love it. So let's get out. I'm not doing a full game, it's too slow. Let's see what we can do in our shop and see if we can't like buy anything.
Yeah, what can we get for our 120 credits?
Greetings.
You can't even afford an engine.
And I'm the owner of this here junk shop.
I know.
You need parts for your ship. I got them all right here.
I got it right here.
Things work around here.
There is nothing I want less than that.
Okay.
I so we got engine.
You start by buying ship hull, wings, or engine.
You can't afford... Well, you can afford that. You can buy a single wing.
Without those, you're gonna need a lot more than your good looks to buy some ship parts. I'm talking the credits. Looks like you
don't... Oh, brother. Okay, so there's a lot you have to buy.
Oh, this is complicated.
Yeah, so let's go.
You're gonna have to play the sensual game with that one guy over and over again.
It's in the hangar.
Welcome to my ship hangar.
Okay, I can just see what my ships are here. No, thank you. I'm out. So, that's Jabba's game galaxy, Star Wars Maths. It is what it is.
Huh. Well, some of that was math, and some of it was checkers, and all of it was disturbing. Thank you, Alex. Do I feel like I know more now than I did before the stream? I guess in terms of Star Wars content, yes, but in terms of educational value, I think I forgot a few things. So it's kind of a wash. But that's Star Wars learning games for PC. There sure were a whole bunch of them. There's one more!
Yeah, there's the title piece. You forgot about it, didn't you?
Yes.
It's staring you right in the face.
Oh no, you're not going to play this.
I have to play this. Danny.
Oh my god.
Next on the docket.
I thought we were all done, and then Alex just pulls me right back in.
The final PC game.
The final PC game, and the fourth Star Wars learning game released in the year 2000. It's Jar Jar's Journey.
Jar Jar's Journey.
Let's go on Jar Jar's Journey.
Mm-hmm. He's on a journey, babe. This is released November 15th, 2000, and this is the final PC and the final educational game.
They were cranking them out in 2000, mm-hmm. Damn.
After this, Lucas Learning, well, the final game by, I should say, final, it's not the final PC game ever, it's the final PC game by Lucas Learning. After this, they did Super Bombad Racing for PS2, canceled the Mac game, and got folded, as I mentioned, into Edutopia, or the George Lucas Educational Foundation.
Wow.
So this is last call for the children's multimedia Star Wars games.
Well, it's not for lack of trying. They definitely made plenty of games. They milked the franchise as much as they could. Franchise, hell, they milked that one movie as much as they could.
Mm-hmm.
All your beloved characters, such as this stereotype and this other stereotype.
There we go.
One last hurrah for Lucas Learning.
Do you like Jar Jar?
Do I?
He's in an entirely different style here, right?
That's very Looney Tunes.
Chicken.
All right, let me know if this is too loud or too quiet, because there's a lot of stuff in this
one.
Hello, Danny. I'm Jar Jar Binks.
Did he say hello, Danny?
So happy you've come.
Dairy, but I like that. No, it's Danny now.
Thank you, Simon the Digger, for 31 months. I'm disturbed, but thank you.
Thank you so much.
If you have a favorite page and want to see it again, click on this button. And if you are brave enough to try some of the games, click on this button.
Are we brave?
If you are done playing the game and want to leave the program, click on this button here.
So this one seems like the UE and everything, it seems like the budget's running low. It seems like they may know that this is the end of the time.
This is way less complex than the other ones, way less overwrought.
So, I don't want to go through the entire storybook. There's 14. Do you want to do all 14 pages?
No.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's start from the beginning, though, and...
Show me page 69.
There's only 14. I would love to, though.
Hell.
So, this game has a secret that I'll reveal in a second.
What a great start.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this really is just Jar Jar's journey. Just screw the rest of the movie.
One brisk morning when I was digging for my breakfast. Battle droids came crashing through the swamp. A brave Jedi named Qui-Gon saved me. The battle droids were trying to take over my planet. We had to find help.
There are surprises hidden on every screen. Click on the screen to find them.
I'm the talking clam.
That clam is the Rolo of this game. I despise them.
Yikes! I almost became a Gungan garnish. Good thing those Jedi saved me. I wonder where they're going.
Totally Rolo vibes. Like, spot on.
And you can just click around as you can in all these games.
Mm-hmm.
Like, on the droids.
Roger, roger.
Yes, the Roger, roger droids.
Those are my favorite. I'm sorry, I love these battle droids.
Go.
Oh, I thought you were looking for battle droids.
It's a lot of that.
That kind of got me.
I'm Qui-Gon Jinn. I'm a Jedi Knight. And this is my Padawan learner, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Be careful. There are battle droids about.
Where? Where are these battle droids?
Be careful. We need to hurry.
Roger, roger. Run away! Run away!
And I think I can click on Obi-Wan here.
I can handle this one, Master.
Whoa! Force push.
Can I click on Jar Jar? So you can change some wording on the page. So you can say instead of crashing.
Smashing! Trampling! Crashing!
And here's the game's secret.
Yeah.
Do you remember how there were all those original songs in that one game we played earlier?
Are there more songs?
Each? This is where you could tell that things started petering out, because there are two songs per page, and let's just start with one.
Yeah, play it.
Battle droids are made to fight.
They don't know they're wrong from right.
Battle droids, they take their shots.
They don't care, they're just robots.
I.
The birds go squeak, other creatures go eek. When you step in a swamp, it goes slush, slush, slush. For a swamp's all wet and a mess. but mush, mush, mush.
Let's go to a different page, huh? I'm not going to click on everything in the other pages, but I do want to hear the songs at least.
I don't know what to say. I am dumbstruck by this.
To escape the battle droids, we swam to Otto Gunga.
Two per page, you say.
Safe in the underwater bubble city. Only Gungans like me knew how to find it.
Darth Brooks.
In Otto Gunga, we met the Gungan leader, Boss Nass. The Jedi asked Boss Nass for help. He gave us a bongo so we could go to Theed and warn Naboo's queen about the battle droids. But to get there, we would have to travel through the planet's core.
So I'm not clicking on any of the things here.
We're right, just play the music.
Songs, yeah.
For going through the core, a bongo's sure to score. Cause nothing beats a submarine that travels shore to shore. Bongo sub, moving with great speed. Has a long and spinning tail and travels through the sea.
And,
planets, they are huge and round. They go around the sun. If you
hey, they don't know what Earth is.
Are, remember, Earth is one.
This is playing fast and loose with the canon. They refer to droids as robots. They refer to Earth. What is going on here?
Click on a button to visit.
So we're going to go through just different pages.
Jar Jar is merging the universes, and I don't like it. He's doing it through song. That's the worst part.
Yeah, someone clip out bongo sub and make it a sub notification.
Bongo sub, bongo sub.
So we're not going to go through every page, but...
Chubo, you can have that one.
Please take it, Chubo. So yeah, this you could tell is the end of the games of the company's lifespan. There's a lot of songs per page, but they get lazier and lazier as they go on.
Yeah.
They repeat the tunes a lot, so I don't want to go through everyone. But Danny, I want you to select a couple of pages for us to go through before we end the stream.
Okay, how about page 11?
Okay. Ooh, looks like a pod race.
Yeah.
I do want to try the R2-D2 page because I want there to be an R2-D2 song.
I hoped I could win the race.
Oh, he's here!
I wanted to help.
Yet another Anakin.
Their starship, but winning wouldn't be easy. At the pod race, Jabba the Hutt rang the starting bell. The other pod racers took off, but my pod racer wouldn't start. By the time I got going, I was already far behind. I had to catch up to help my friends.
Sing it, Anakin.
There's a Jabba song and a Far song.
Blubba, slubba, mama, Jabba.
So do you see what I mean? That they like...
I see what you mean now about them putting in less effort as the pages go on.
A droid once came to Jabba's place and knocked upon the door.
Alex is doing a jaunty dance.
When no one came to answer it, he tried again once more. This time he rang the great big gong and out a loud note sang. Then Jabba opened up the door to ask him if he rang.
I don't even know anymore.
Away apart, opposed to near, the great distance to a star.
Jesus.
When something is out there and not close to you, we say that thing is far.
Get educated, folks. All right, let's choose a couple more pages.
Forget everything I said about all the other games resembling CDI games. This is the one. This one, I'm convinced, is a port directly from the Philips CDI.
Okay, I want to do this one just to see if there's an R2-D2 song.
Okay.
But we weren't free from danger yet. As we started on our journey, a group of enemy starfighters tried to stop us. My starship was damaged. A droid named R2-D2 fixed the shields and saved us all.
There is no R2-D2 song. This
maybe one of these songs will be a tribute.
There is one of the mini-games. We're going to do one of the mini-games at least.
Jar Jar took a journey. He traveled far from home. From Naboo Green to Tatooine. He didn't go alone.
I love
Jar
Filk.
Jar Jar took a journey. He took a long, long trip. He went to strange and weird new worlds upon a silver ship.
Yeah, real Raffy vibes.
To travel to another planet, you can't walk, it's way too slow. Better get yourself a starship, that's the light speed way to go.
Okay, I will.
Let's play one of the games here.
Let's get a starship.
The ship is in trouble. Help R2-D2 relay the power for the shields.
Oh, I remember this part from the movie. Sounds, you see? There were other R2s helping him out, and they all got blown away, but he was the sole survivor.
That part was really funny. I'm sorry.
R2-D2's a badass.
Okay, here we go. Now it's your turn.
I see what you're doing.
Good.
I'm picking up what you're throwing down.
Now watch the lights carefully. Now it's your...
Performance is better in this game.
Ready for another light?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try it again, but with three lights this time.
Doot, doot, doot. That is a rather hastily drawn R2, isn't it?
I
very low detail.
Oh my god.
You're doing great. We're getting power.
Let's throw in another yellow. Oh. Do it wrong.
Very good job. Well done. Click here to start playing.
Was it though?
What?
It just took control away from you. It's like, yeah, you did great.
Okay. You want to do one more page?
Yes.
All right. We got a lot. Oh. Is this the one where he talks to Anakin about how he's not going to free his mother from slavery?
I invited the visitors to take shelter from the storm at my house.
That's good.
Jar Jar looks high as shit.
My new friends. They needed help to continue on their journey. So I offered to enter my pod racer in the Bunta Eve race. If I won, Watto would keep the prize money and give my friends the new hyperdrive generator.
Okay, let's do the song about introduced.
Sure.
When R2 met C-3PO, a world so far away, they met in little Annie's house on a dusty sandstorm day.
Little Annie.
They traded names and numbers there. What
let's keep in touch.
As they met for the very first time, as they were introduced.
They gave each other their phone numbers. It was love at first sight.
Listen, it is my OTP in this stupid universe. I love there are all these cute little songs and this cute little, and they're like trying to put this in a cute little story about like this child is going to kill so many children when he grows up. It's
yeah.
So.
All of them.
He is a.
They fly like speeders, fast as light. Go, pod racer, go. Anakin, made when that's out of sight.
Go, pod racer, go.
Cat's a Bulba, you can do it. Go, pod racer, go.
He can't catch you, he just blew it. Go, pod racer, go.
Hurry now and pick up the pace. Go, pod racer, go. Go the fastest and win the race. Go, pod racer, go.
It's like classic songs of Americana, but put to Star Wars.
Button to visit another screen.
Let's see a couple more games, then I think we're done here. Unless you want to hear some more. I don't know. Yes, we want to do Jar Jar's Coloring Center. Fuck all of this.
Jar Jar's Bongo Maze is the thing I saw.
Okay.
Right? Yeah. Okay. Feel free to pause the stream and print these out.
Oh, God.
If you want to color
so
these.
Sad.
You want to color your own Jar Jar? Here's your chance. You don't even gotta buy the game. We're giving you a free service
Are you done coloring?
You know, I'm going to do the most depressing one. Hold on.
Yeah, all right.
Sorry.
Great!
That's goth.
Somewhere on the picture where this picture should be.
It's
they're living in a Flintstones house.
Nice orange sunset. I don't know.
Color a dino jar.
Blue milk here.
Yeah, right. Uh-huh. This is the color palette they give you, huh? Okay.
Do you like that noise, Danny?
Yeah, I love it. I love it when it's repeated over and over again.
Yeah, this is an IKEA. This is a space IKEA set, so it's all kind of got the same color scheme going on.
I'm not getting paid enough for this. Also, I have a bad feeling about this.
All right. I think the... Yeah, it's...
Right. Yeah, that should be green, too.
No. Oh, yeah. You know what? Listen, they got a very good deal at Space IKEA. She is... she is, unfortunately... Oh, we're getting raided. Oh, hey, great. Thank you, Bad Weed, for the raid.
Yeah, thank you. Welcome, everybody.
We're about to end, and this game is...
You came in on a hell of a game. This is Jar Jar's Journey for PC. It includes coloring books.
And this guy is red with anger.
Songs.
Over his mom not being freed from slavery. No, I don't like that. Should he be purple with anger?
Enraged Anakin. There you go.
He's purple because he's holding his
breath. Now he's a character from Doug.
Oh, I want to make her Doug Core too. All
yeah,
right.
They're all in the same family.
Uh-huh, it's Ducktown.
Those who came in from Bad Weed, welcome.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed that commercial you just saw. Hopefully it was a Star Wars commercial. Oh. We're playing a bunch of educational Star Wars games for PC. This has been a hell of a stream. The
Do
one
you
thing
like
that unites
noise?
The one thing that unites all these games, weirdly enough, is music. Specifically vocal songs about the Star Wars universe, but for kids. So much singing.
Hey, do you like this noise? I know I keep asking,
please,
but do you like it?
You're killing me. This noise is just, it's killing me.
I don't know. Blue. Dabba D.
Where are her legs? Oh my god!
They didn't care! Oh my god!
They didn't give a fuck!
Do you see what I mean? That by the time this Jar Jar's Journey came out, like, the Lucas learning team had just kind of pieced. They're like, uh-uh.
Okay, so... To close things out, I want you to go back and click on the bongo race.
Okay.
I want to see what that is. And then I want to close out with one final song.
Okay.
For the folks who just came
flesh
in.
Flesh furniture. Oh, no.
Yeah. Natural flesh furniture.
Just some kind of, just peach shit. There we go. What do you think, Danny?
There,
now. Am I going to get a job at Lucasfilm?
I think you're now blocked from working there.
That's fine.
You're also blocked by George Lucas on Twitter. Bongo maze.
You're gonna be very disappointed in the bongo maze. I'm so sorry.
Yikes a buoy! The bongo is lost in the core. Help us find the way to feed. Click here to start playing. Do you need help?
Let's do medium.
Okie dokie.
Okie dokie.
So this really does have the CDI feel.
See? The bongo
maze. It's just a maze.
Sorry, yeah.
I don't know what I was expecting. Well, you did it.
I am smarter than a six-year-old.
Let's try again.
Okay, go back to that storybook, pick a random page, and whatever song you pick is going to be our send-off song for this episode of Multimedia Monday. You know, I'm glad we played these games. I'm also going to be glad we're never going to see these again. Page 14. Close
Final
out the
page.
Story. One last song to sum up Star
Anakin
Wars Episode 1.
Mother, said goodbye.
Oh, no.
He was very brave as he left her. With our new friend Anakin, we left Tatooine. We would travel to other worlds together. On Naboo, Anakin, Jar Jar, and the Queen would save the people from the battle droids.
You don't get to see it, though, don't worry.
The course is charted for Coruscant. We'll leave when everyone is aboard.
Travel.
I wanna hear the clam one more time. There's All a clam right. on every page, and they're always awful. So what's final clam?
Thank you,
Worth
Alex.
It more than anything I've ever clicked in my life. Okay.
You did good.
I do want to click on some things here. R2, uh-huh.
Boing. Oh, R2.
What does Jar Jar say? Hilarious.
Old no frills
the queen
Obi-Wan.
Will be pleased.
And you, Annie.
Yeah!
Wait, no! I wanted to...
Well, you did it. You wrapped up the story.
No
more
songs.
No, no,
no. We're going back to hearing the songs. No, no. No, no. Don't you dare.
And that is the end of Star Wars Episode 1.
That's our story.
No, Jar Jar, no, no. There's a Tatooine song, Jar Jar.
We all became heroes.
and Anakin began training to be a Jedi just like Qui-Gon.
It worked out great.
That's a tale for another time.
It's fine. Don't worry about it. Okay, come on. Okay, let's try that one more time. Sorry. This time I'll try not to actually finish the game.
Yeah, don't end the story. Okay. We have to listen to the song.
Anakin hugged his mother and said goodbye. He was very brave as he left her.
Can you not skip this?
With our new friend Anakin, we left Tatooine. We would travel. No.
Click on his mouth to close it.
On Naboo,
just pinch his lips shut.
And the queen would save the people. All
right, we got two songs left.
The course is charted for Coruscant.
One song left.
We leave when everyone is aboard.
Let's do it.
Oh, there isn't a Tatooine song. Just together. Well, final song of the night.
Together's when you're not alone, when you're with someone else. If you have a friend nearby, then you're not by yourself. When people sit there side by side, they're called birds of a feather. When you're not far away from me, then we are both together.
This does suck.
Yeah, end on a different song.
I actually
end on the
you.
Travel.
Hold on. No. That was really bad. Jar Jar, no. Hold on.
Welcome to the stream that never ends. I'm going to be watching this until 11 o'clock at night. I'm going to listen to every single song in this game.
Lucky number 12.
I'm gaining on him. My pod race was very fast. I zoomed past everyone except Sebulba, the champion pod racer. He tried some tricks to make me crash. No one knew who would win.
The fast song. Or the crash song.
The pod race is a thrill ride, bam and smash.
Oh, they got Johnny Cash.
Watch out for the hillside slam and bash. You better handle it with care and a helmet you should wear. And put your seatbelt on in case you crash.
Into a ring of fire.
And last but not least, is it time to zoom?
Yeah.
A car goes fast as it rockets on past, and the sound it makes is vroom, vroom, vroom. A ship speeds out of sight, very near the speed of light, and the sound it makes is zoom, zoom, zoom.
Folks, we are now much more well acquainted with the Star Wars universe through the venue of song and via multimedia PC games. Are you sure you want to exit?
Okay. Bye for now.
Yeah, for now. We'll be back with more Jar Jar games as we uncover them. Wow, that was Jar Jar's journey. And it feels like we've been on a journey indeed, across multiple games, across a very short 3 years in which so many Episode 1 games were released for PC. A lot of them for kids, a lot of them very CDI-ish in presentation, so of course, I loved every single one of them.
So yeah, Lucas, that was the last PC game Lucas Learning made, then they did Super Bombad Racing for PS2, and that's it.
Kaput.
Yeah.
That's it. Wow. I know so much more about the Star Wars universe now, and that's even after you've been watching the movies again.
Yeah.
Telling me about your favorite parts. Just waiting. I bet you've been playing these games all week being like, oh, I can't wait to torture Danny with this shit.
Actually, yeah, this weekend I was, when I got to the original Anakin songs, I was like, oh my god, Danny's gonna,
Incredible. Incredible. Thanks for watching, everyone. This has been another successful Multimedia Monday, by which I mean we survived it. And that's really all I can ask for. Tune in this Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central, where I am going to attempt to scale the Tower of Druaga, the famously impossible video game from the early 80s. So impossible that people couldn't figure it out for years and years and years, and you actually need many external hint guides just to figure out what to do, where to go, and how to beat the game. With any luck, I'm going to go all the way through it on Wednesday, and I'm going to need you there to wish me luck. I'm going to need all the cheers, all the people cheering me on as possible, because this game's on a whole different level, and
for
I can't wait. Alex, give us a little wrap-up. I'm going to look for a host.
All right. Thank you all so very much for watching. We are on Patreon, patreon.com/retropals. If you pitch in $5 a month, you get to vote on what we play every Wednesday. And this Wednesday, you wanted to torture Danny. And that's fine. It is always a good time.
A lot of torturing Danny going on this week. I'm sensing a theme.
So do support us there if you feel the need. And we are also on YouTube, youtube.com/retropals. We just put up our AM2 highlight. So if you want to see us going through Fighters Megamix and playing a lot of fun AM2 games for the Saturn, do check that out. It's a good one.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Why not do that? Oh my god, Dino, are you really doing this?
Hmm.
Where is he? I have to see where in the games he is. Dino right now is using new emulator technology to play Streets of Rage 1, 2, and 3 simultaneously.
No.
In that it switches from game to game every time it detects an enemy being killed. So if he kills a guy in Streets of Rage 1, goes to Streets of Rage 2, and so on and so on and so on. This looked nuts when I was watching this earlier, so let's go ahead and give him a raid. Oh man, there's robots in Streets of Rage 3? They're all hopping around? They look a lot like that droid you made earlier. Check it out.
Oh, cool. That is my droid.
Yeah, see?
Nice.
A little bit of continuity between streams. So I'm going to set the raid to happen right about... Got to do the thing. Hang on. There. The raid has begun. Stick around if you want to see some true madness, courtesy of Dino, please. Thanks, everyone, for watching.
Thank you.
We'll see you on Wednesday. Bye.
Have a good week, folks.